everybody, to our next session of Dungeon of the Mad Mage. I would like to establish some kind of a ritual to have our journalist Zoya recap the last session. So if you may or be ready for it, please go on.
All right. So after realizing that we're locked down in the dungeon for the time being, we weren't quite sure if we should go to level 2 or not, and decided to explore the one passage that we didn't explore yet, the one right in front of the entrance we came from, the yawning portal. So the brave hero that we are, we sent our familiars to check. So my owl died, thrown by what was that, a wind elemental, an air elemental, and Esmeralda, Alistair's familiar, checked the other passage and found some goblins, so we decided to leave at it. And we finally, we went back in the map room, one of the secret doors had disappeared. We checked the buttons to see if they said the same, and as far as we know, the map looks the same and the buttons still have the same messages. We took a short rest. We had a bit of sharing of our backstories and general talk. I got my owl back. And then we finally, after 7 sessions, decided to proceed to level 2. Where we arrived to find a room with goblins. And encountered a goblin named Sniggle. He seemed to be rather friendly, which was good because we were not looking forward to another fight, especially not with a room full of goblins, and not knowing if we were able to go back to level 1 or not. But Sniggle seemed to be quite nice, and he actually led us to a bazaar. We found out that they had a goblin leader named Yek, and that he is apparently cursed. Zoya also made a good friend with a goblin named Snuggle, who gave her a slightly magical, nightcap, which Zoya can totally use because it puts you into magical sleep, and as an elf, that will totally work. So if any of you guys that's not an elf needs a good night's sleep, hit me up. I cleaned some of the things for him. After that, we had a bit of a chat with people there at Bazaar, asked different questions, looked a bit around what kind of items they had, and we managed to find a place to stay, and we had a long rest there, and Zoya's curse was finally lifted, so she didn't feel vulnerable anymore, but apparently I caught whatever Orlin caught, and now I feel weird pain when I do magic. Which is amazing now that we have more spells. We went and talked to Yek. We found out that he's a human. Or a goblin cursed to look like a human, we're not quite sure there. He was a bit weird, his speech was a bit faltering, and he had a band on his head. Like a magical item. Which probably has something to do with the curse that he has. They also had a slave they were about to offer, a dwarf, which Orlin happily purchased. She wanted to set him free, though. He didn't really like us. He would go between, there was a conversation led through message, so no one could listen in. And it was a bit of between, I'm gonna kill you guys and I hate you guys, but also please let me free and protect me. So we're not quite sure what to do with this guy. We found out that he was a friend with Halith, and he wants us to protect him from him. We found out that the dwarf's name is Copper Stormforge, We offered to protect the dwarf, but we freed him, but he's not a slave now, but he's a prisoner now. That's, I think, how you worded it, right, Orlin?
Yeah, I just wanted to add that I don't know if... I think I told you that, but, like, he and his party murdered Halef and threw him in the hole, and then that's why he's now mad at the copper, yes.
Yeah, and we found out that the reason they had a bit of issues with Halef was that he was constantly talking about Orkin, which is a goddess of trade. He would lecture the group and telling them that they weren't serving her right and stuff like that, and they eventually got fed up with him and left him there to die. So we were still deciding what exactly we would do about him, and that's pretty much where we stopped.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
I think that's all. I hope I didn't miss any of the important information there.
Anything that the group wants to add? Is anything missing for you guys?
Nope.
I've already added what I need to add.
Yeah. Not that I'm aware of. These are pretty much the most important details.
Okay. Good. Stage is yours, people.
Okay, I think the first thing I want to do is give Copper a ration. So I pull out one of my rations that I have and hand it over to Copper and then turn back to my...
Is he still... Did you leave him handcuffed or...
Yeah, we didn't uncuff him. We just...
You didn't. Okay, so yeah, then he has issues taking the ration from you, but...
I have to feed him.
Yeah, well, no, like, I think the main issue is he's still gagged, isn't it?
No, he's been screaming from the top of his lungs.
No,
but we gagged him again after he...
Yes. Excuse me.
Oh, man, okay,
Do you need help there, Orlin, or...?
Well, I think he might want to, like, eat something that might make him a little less cranky, but,
maybe.
He might
so.
Also scream if we ungag him, so does anyone... Like, does anyone have, like, a magical mouth-gagging spells?
like, silence or something?
Yeah, nope. I don't know.
I mean, I have a nightcap that gives you good sleep. Maybe that would calm him a bit.
Oh, no, I'd like to...
You can cast Tiny Hut over him, and you won't hear anything outside, right?
Does it?
No, I think he will. That was, like, the ruling, wasn't it? Yeah, no. Well, you know.
Yeah.
And Alicent and... Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I
could command him to be silent. That's
And
an
I
option.
Have a warhammer.
Yeah, I think charming him would be, like, good on long term either.
Command isn't technically a charm, is it? It's just...
No, it's an enchantment, divination, enchantment, magic.
No,
it's
but
not...
I think it's technically counts as a charm.
Yeah, but it doesn't. It won't make him angry.
No.
After it's gone. Right.
No.
Well. I mean, go ahead, I guess.
I mean, just tell him that if he screams, he doesn't get any food. That's...
Okay, well, that might work. I mean, I'm not very intimidating. Does anyone else want to maybe, like, try to intimidate him a little bit? He's still under the effects of phantasmal force right now, isn't he, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Should be.
Yeah.
I have +2 on intimidation, but knowing my roles, I probably will make him laugh.
Could you quickly recap what the Phantasmal Force effect exactly was on Copper?
It was just basically like his ears are a little bit blocked, so he can't hear anything, but, you know, not in an alarming way.
So he's deaf.
Yeah, but like not like, oh my god, I can't hear anything anymore, more than like, oh, it's kind of weird, like...
That fuzzy ear sound?
Yeah, you know?
Okay, then try your luck on charming, intimidating, whatever.
Well, who does anyone? I mean, Elasha, you do look very, very intimidating, I think. So.
True.
I mean, don't take it like a wrong offense, way. Right? I think it's awesome that you look intimidating. But
I mean, come on, any man would be quite intimidated by that bust. Come on.
Yes, I get that a lot. So I'm sometimes struggling with it, but yeah, that's just my nature. You have to accept what you are. Of course, if you guys think that that's the way that we can do this, then I will try my best to make him calm down.
Okay. I hand Elasha the ration. And also release my concentration on Copper's phantasmal force so he can hear again.
All right, I take the rations, I step over right in front of Copper. He's probably sitting on the ground, right?
He's like not sitting, he's standing. But standing. For you personally, as a huge half orc, it's not much of a difference.
All right. So I get down on one knee so I can actually look him in the eyes. I have the rations in my hand, in my left hand. And I tell him, Copper, we have some food for you, and you haven't been really, what is it, like?
Cooperative.
Yeah, cooperative so far. I would like to give you the food, and we would take off the mouth gag so you could actually eat something. To do that, you have to stay silent and stop screaming. And if you don't, we will just force feed you this and make you not scream anymore. Okay?
Okay, now there is your intimidation. Okay. Let me see.
He feels intimidated.
He looks at you for a couple of seconds, and his face is not as red anymore as before, and he is mumbling something, which is still pretty loud, but that is probably due to his hearing problem.
He doesn't have that anymore. I released Phantasmal Force.
Ah, completely?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
I mean, I can't.
Yeah.
You know.
And he was hearing me.
He looks like he's calming down a bit.
All right. Okay. If you understand what I'm saying and you're okay with it, then please just nod your head.
He slowly nods.
Okay. All right, guys. So with my right hand, I just undo the gag thingy. And yeah. And we have to take off the handcuffs as well, right? I guess.
He doesn't need them to chew, but...
Oh, true. Okay, so yeah, I just take off the mouth gag and I don't know, we have some bread or something, I guess?
It's rations, it's bread, some dried meat.
All right.
Yeah, stuff that can hold a couple of days without being cooled or...
Yeah.
Okay, you release the gag and he mumbles, or you're an ugly looking bitch.
I
come again? I didn't fully understand.
You just said something lovely in Dwarvish, don't worry.
I said you're a lovely princess, my dear.
Oh, that's better. Thank you. So, I break off some bread and I just feed it to him. Well, not forcefully, but also not like romantic movies. Yeah, and I just give him some of the rations so he can chew on it.
Okay, he accepts the food and chews on the ration. With every bite, he is mumbling something with a closed mouth that you can't understand.
At least he's not screaming anymore, so that's good.
Good job, Elasha. That was good.
Thanks.
Let's go into a corner and talk about this. I think, without him hearing. I go over to the far corner here.
I just, like, I fed him most of it, so I just take another big chunk, put it in his mouth so he has something to do while we're gone. And I step over again as well. But I'm staying, like, a little bit to the door.
Mm. So I sort of turn to everyone and say, well, I whisper, well, I the way I see it, we only have two real options. We either take him with us and risk us, like, getting killed or robbed. And also, as soon as we run into Helleth, he's gonna die. Or
which
we...
one?
Copper, I think. I don't... personally don't think we should defend him. He did murder. Like, straight up murder Helleth.
And that is quite immoral, so I also have no qualms with the... something happening to him down the road, but could be useful to us until then. Certainly.
Yeah, he could also be a risk. Well, the other option is basically we just sort of let him go, and he'll also die. There's no way up. So, well.
But that'd be slightly boring, wouldn't it?
Well, I think we should give him the choice between those two things. But I wanted to ask all of you if you would be okay with him, with taking him with us, in case he wants that.
So long as he doesn't cause a ruckus, I'm perfectly fine.
Yeah.
You bought it, you can do whatever you want with him.
Sure, he is yours.
Well, I'll be honest, I think he'll rob us blind and maybe stab us as well, so...
I am not very confident in his motives to, like, calm down and not cause any problems. So,
And about the stabbing, I have quite a bit of experience of stabbing myself, so don't worry too much about that.
Well, you know,
I tend to stab back. I don't feel vulnerable anymore, you know, so... I'm pretty confident I could take him.
Well, the thing is, he's currently almost butt naked, and he's unarmed, so the only way he'd stab us is with his fingers, and I don't think that's going to go through some of our armor here if we keep ourselves.
But then is the question, what do we gain of taking him with us? Like, what can he provide really for us?
The goblins imprisoned him because he stole from them, so I don't think he has problems with stealing either.
Well, maybe he's only racist towards goblins? I mean, he did seem to get along fine with the rest of the party other than Hallett.
Except then.
Oh, I don't think they didn't... well, you know, he doesn't seem like the kind of character that has much of a moral compass, in my opinion.
Mm, yeah.
I think we should... try to talk to him, and maybe he has, like, some information.
Well, also, like, let's be real. If the goblin knew what we did upstairs, they might not be that friendly towards us either.
True.
So it's a bit of a perspective thing.
Well,
here.
What happens on the first level stays on the first level.
I know,
level.
Right?
Well, you know, not necessarily. They might know what we did. Like, not all goblins are friends with each other. Maybe they were, like... That was a rival clan of goblins, you know?
Well,
oh,
on that
subject, I detected some magic coming off the little circlet that Yek was wearing.
Mm.
So I don't know if we can Well, I don't know. Let's deal with that later, yeah. I guess.
Yeah, I think that's also a thing, like, Snuggles told us that, or no, another one, I think. Who told us this? Snuggles, or was it another? I don't know, like, he told us that, Yak is cursed, and you sense some magic from the circlet.
No, so... it was the guy that was selling the weapons.
Yeah. Sniggles was the one in the beginning, and Snuggles was one of the merchants.
Yeah, exactly. Snuggles was the one that sold me the cap of good sleep.
Alright. So, I mean, like, there's two things. We have the... how did they call him? Xenethian?
Xenethor?
Yeah, but he has like his colors or something are here, he said.
Apostles, yeah, the, or something, yes.
Apprentices. The
apostles, exactly. So we have like those that are currently threatening the goblins. And there was another party, I think, that is also threatening them. And then we have the curse on Yek. So, the question is what we guys think is more important. Like, even if we lift the curse from Yek right now, he might not be too happy about it, because he seemed to very, very much like it.
But maybe the curse is that he likes it so much.
True that.
You know?
So the question I was asking myself is, like, do we gain something if we help the goblins first and then maybe try to take off the curse?
Yeah, like, I'm not sure. I mean, do any of you even have an idea how we could go about taking off the curse?
Well, I mean, we have, like, a lot of people. We have sneaky people with invisibility.
And some persuasive people, depending on our mood.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, we have different kind of ways to be persuasive, yeah.
True.
Well, we'd need to, like, learn his behavioral patterns first, I think. Like, I think no matter how many invisible people we are, if there's a room full of goblins, they're gonna notice something. And even then, after we take off the circlet, they're not gonna all be super, like, stoked about it instantly, I think. You heard what they said, you're not allowed to cast magic in the sight of a goblin.
Yeah, that was Mech, Yek.
Yeah, like, but
the other ones,
all...
the other ones were, I don't know, I didn't feel any...
I mean,
any...
if we get Yek on his own, he's technically looking at least like a human, so it's not a goblin.
Yeah.
So,
and, I mean, if
we
could
cast magic in front of Yek, right?
And if we get Yek on his own, then we can sort of remove the circlet and, like, gauge the situation. You won't have, like, 10 other goblins there that think, well, we have stolen something, you know?
I personally think we should do something about the warring tribes that are trying to go against the goblins first. Maybe we can win over his trust and then get him alone that way.
Yeah, I think that's the more pressing problem anyway. But I think the most pressing problem right now is, and I point at Copper, you know?
Yeah. Coppers.
All right, I'll make him an offer.
Maybe I just thought about something. Like, we're not really sure yet on what to do with him and how useful he could be. So while we, for example, go out and try to deal with some of them, what if, like, we keep him here and maybe, like, someone could supervise him so he doesn't make any.
Yeah, maybe Alistair could help us with that.
Here's what I'm thinking. I sort of bought him so he wouldn't be a slave. And I think in order to, like, not have a slave, we'll have to give him a choice.
Well, we will definitely give him a choice, but maybe he has some information for us that we can later. Or he could help us, like, creating a diversion or something as well. So Right now, he would just be protected because he's still in a very.
Well, I guess we can offer him that as a third choice, right? You stay here. You're not allowed to leave, though, I guess. I don't know.
Why don't we get him some clothes first?
Why would he need clothes? Well, I don't know.
If we leave him, like, if we let him just go like that, he doesn't have weapons, he doesn't have clothes, he doesn't have anything to eat, and he can't go outside, so for him it's probably not the best.
I mean, he must have had some kind of equipment when they got him. Maybe we can find out where at least his clothes went.
Yeah, but if he stole from them, I doubt that they won't. If they will just give it to us or to him back.
Well, I mean, we can purchase some like cheaper stuff, I guess, in the market as well. But I don't know. I mean, yeah, you're right. Like, it's kind of a non-choice to sort of stay with us and maybe live, and don't stay with us and definitely die. But I don't know. I think he's like an odious little dwarf, but we should give him a choice, just, you know, because that's what being free is about, and, you know, I wanted to free him, not enslave him again.
Yeah, I mean, we can try and see what his reaction is.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'll go over then. I approach Copper. Is he still eating, or what's going on with him?
No, he's done. He was trying to listen to you all of the time.
Does he look like he heard anything?
How does someone look like he heard something?
Does he look like scared or like angry or?
No, he is pretty neutral. So, yeah, if you said something that might have offended him or scare him, he is he's having a good poker face, so you can't really tell.
Okay, well, so I sort of lean down to him a little bit and say, well, listen, the way we see it, you have three choices. You can either come with us, but you might run into Helleth. We will not necessarily defend you against him. And we'll let you free if we get to Skullport, you know, if we get there. Or we can just release you now, but we'll have to let you know that the exit through the Yawning Portal is closed right now. So you'll have to fend for yourself. Or we can just let you stay here and we'll put a guard here. The guard might be a goblin at some point. What do you prefer?
And we will come back.
We will come back for you.
Yeah. So those are your options, are you withered flower of a human?
Well, have you seen a mirror recently?
I just chuckle a little bit.
You have better idea, Copper.
You release me and I'm gonna struggle that parody of a human on his throne.
Well, we can't do that. We'll release you somewhere out of the way.
Yeah, just release me wherever you want, and I don't want to go with you. I just want to get out of here.
I'll have to reiterate. The Yawning Portal is closed. There might not be a way to get out right now. But, Well,
okay.
Oh,
he's not listening.
Okay, I have a plan for this. So, can we like gag him again?
Of course. He can't do anything against it, so.
Well, he struggled against it last time, so I had to roll and everything.
Well, he's handcuffed,
know?
So he's, he's not really.
I will help you.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay,
do I have
to
roll?
Him and gag him again? No. Nope.
Okay. And then I'd like to like rip a little bit of my shirt or whatever, and also bind his eyes. And then I'll message Soya. Soya, can you make me invisible or like for how long can you make me invisible?
Make you invisible. I can only make myself invisible.
Oh no. Okay.
I reply. Wait, I reply with message.
Yes.
Message as well, so I don't have to whisper it.
Okay. Crap. Do you have anything that can make me more stealthy?
Wait. Who helped us with that last time? Was it Alice or Lasha?
Alice.
Yeah.
Yes, I do indeed have a spell to help you.
Well, you didn't hear that, but I'll message you.
I'm
telling you. Alice, do you have anything that can make me stealthy?
Yes, I do indeed.
How long does it last?
Up to an hour.
Okay. Well,
that should be enough.
Okay. How can I let everyone know this plan? I'll like motion to everyone sort of to like come back to the corner.
Okay.
So, what's your plan?
I whisper like even more quietly right now. Okay, we're gonna go back to the first level and release him somewhere and like turn him around a little bit. Then we're gonna take off the blindfold and run away. And then he won't know where he is, which, you know, is just as well. He doesn't know where he is right now either. And he can't follow us and can't bother us anymore. For nice, we can give him a knife, you know. That's my plan.
Can't really go. And the issue, like, he can't really go anywhere from the first level, right? Or as far as
yeah, exactly.
So but he will eventually come back down to the second floor.
Yeah, but it'll take him a while. He won't know where we are by then. And there's still the goblins.
Yeah, but if they end up like,
I mean, how else?
Them again,
how else do you?
You did all that thing for nothing.
Also, he would technically be. You're a slave in their eyes, so you would technically be responsible for his actions.
Yes.
What else?
He is your property.
Do you want to do? Like, does anyone else have a better idea?
I mean, we can leave him here and.
He wants to be released, though.
Release him if we find, like, another floor, or just, like, go far enough out of. Like, at some point there won't be like goblins, I think. And then we can just
while you
them.
Are conspiring against the poor dwarf, you hear rumbling noises from the other side of the door, and some really loud voices shouting something in goblin.
You want to write, Eric?
It is not loud enough for you to understand it, so you probably need to step outside and see what's happening.
There seems to be some commotion outside.
Well,
yeah.
I guess there's some pressing issues right now, yeah.
Yeah, let me just check real quick what is
also,
going on.
Sorry, I need to like check on my laundry now. I guess that's maybe a good point. I don't know. So I'll be back in like 5 minutes, if that's okay.
Okay, let's give it 5.
Okay, thank you.
The joys
break.
Of online gaming.
Oh yes, you can do your laundry.
And the good thing is, if you have someone else taking care of it after you put it in the machine.
Well, yeah.
Because that's what I did.
Let's
like,
not compare laundry and stuff with the 16th century where you had to do it for yourself. But I'm personally looking for apartments that has their own washing machine and tumbler. I'm not doing that laundry basement thing again. It's just stupid. I want my own stuff. Taking this stream still running, Nick?
Yeah.
Okay, taking this opportunity to welcome our viewers. Please have a look into the Discord channel Online Gaming and do your vote on what will happen today.
Uh-oh.
It's a guessing vote. It's not deciding vote.
Okay.
Cake followed by dragons. I like cake. Cake is good.
Okay, we have 7 for cake, 2 for dragons, 1 for both, kind of. Thank you, Alan.
Well, D's kind of happened for me. I have cake, like physical cake, not in-game cake, but I do have cake.
Ooh, happy belated birthday.
You kind of always have cake. No, you have a brother that is very much into cake.
Very much into
cake. I don't have cake all the time, that's not true.
But he's baking cake all of the time. Every time I speak to a brother, he's baking cake.
Oh yeah, well, the first time they were baking brownies with his girlfriend, and now they did cake because it was my birthday this week.
Oh yeah, in this case, officially, happy birthday.
Thank you. They were really, really nice about it, by the way. I mentioned once that I see the 30 on the horizon because I turned 29. And so they did a cake with a sun on it, and there's a 30 in the sun, and then there's happy 29th birthday under that, and it was great.
Is your birthday today, or was it?
Yes.
No, it was Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Yeah.
Oh, then happy birthday, a little bit late.
Yeah, I see, so we probably need a birthday calendar for the group.
Yeah, we're gonna be doing a lot of sessions, so we will have some birthdays to celebrate.
Exactly. Yeah. Also, speaking of cake, I always
50 until we're done here.
No, just 50? We're still level.
Yeah, that is still 11 years to go. So you decide.
Yeah, if we keep going this pace, I might turn 50.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, let's do the calendar because I always need a good reason to do cake.
There's always a reason to do cake.
Yeah, I agree with that. Okay, so let's continue.
All right. So, Masha was about to go outside. I'm gonna let you have my owl. If it's okay for you, like my owl's like jump on your shoulder. So if something's going on, she can fly back. And
I mean, you're also allowed to. Join me, that's not a problem, but
yeah,
I will
go
and take a look.
I mean, at least you understand what's going on, and it might be better, like, if we don't all run outside without knowing what's going on.
Alright. Then, I'll just step outside the door.
Mm-hmm.
And okay. I walk forward a little bit.
What you see is, a bigger group of armed men, all of them appear to be bugbears, in armors and weapons. And the leader of those armed bugbears is screaming through the hall, standing in front of the throne north where Yek is sitting on. And as you start to listen in, he is shouting guttural words and is asking for volunteers to join the army of Azrok. A lot of goblins start to gather around those armed men, listening closely.
What was it, Azrok?
Mm-hmm.
Do I know what this is? Do I have any knowledge of that?
Let me quickly check your. You had that one little secret card. Need to check it again. What was that?
I think that was.
Oh no, that was some different stuff. Yeah. Okay. No, you have absolutely no idea what this guy is talking about.
Okay. I'll just. Approach one of the guards there, and I ask him in Goblin, what like in a low voice, I ask him if he could tell me, if he knows what, or he could tell me what Azrok is, or what is going on.
Azrok is the tribe, lives downstairs, lives deeper in Undermountain. Azrok conquered space in Labyrinth.
Ah, I see. All right. I think I walk forward a little bit and I approach that general bugbear, or what he is.
Captain, leader, whatever. Yeah.
Yeah, and I talk in Goblin, of course, and I tell him that I have just heard that you are recruiting for your army or your war band, and we are a group of adventurers, and we are looking for a way to Skullport, and maybe we could
for a second.
And maybe we could be of mutual interest. We could help each other.
Okay. He musters you for a second and replies in Goblin. You adventure group, you and your bird.
No. We are six people. I am the only one who speaks Goblin, so I came to see what is going on out here. We are a very capable team of a lot of different personalities. If you want, I can introduce you to them, but I wanted to check first if there would be any need for that.
We always need help. That is why we're here.
What do you need help for?
You want help driving those ugly dark elves out of our territory?
You have problems with the drow?
Yes. House Avlinga. Yes, he has problems pronouncing that. Difficult drow house name.
Okay.
They unfettered war against peace-loving hobgoblins of the Legion of Azrok, who claimed the ruins of Strom Kuldur as their home years ago. We are righteous inhabitants of Strom Kuldur.
I see. Can I ask you where this place Strom Kuldur is actually?
Below. It is below. It's long ride. It's 4 days. You can travel with us if you want to.
I see. And so if I understand correctly, you have been settling there for years, or have settled there years ago, and now the drow come and want to drive you out of there?
Yes, this is correct.
Okay. I would have to actually talk to my group and
bring forward your group so I can muster them.
All right. I'll be right back. Please, wait for us a few minutes. And I nod at him, and I just move back to our room. All right. So I just fill them in on everything we just talked about with the Azrok and that they settled down there years ago, and now the drow are coming to drive them away. And so right now we have the possibility that we could actually venture way down the labyrinth. Now, the problem is, I don't know how deep it would be. He said like 4 days travel. So,
he is who?
Oh, sorry. Yeah. There's a little warband of the Azrok tribe, and I spoke to their general, to their leader, and they are recruiting people for their fight against the drow. So I don't know, like, I don't want to jump in there and just like have war with the drow instantly because I don't know anything about it.
That would be quite unwise.
So yeah, I just thought that this could be a way to get down there easily and safe, because he said we could trust them and they know the way.
We could ask of them to be their expeditionary force and go ahead of them.
Yeah. But it would be nice to have some sort of escort, I guess.
True.
So did he give you some kind of terms?
We didn't actually talk about that because I first wanted to check back with you guys. As far as I understand, he wants to enlist our help in driving away the drow. So the question then is, if we could like make him believe that we want to help and travel down with him and then just go away, which could also be unwise, as we could make some enemies with the bugbear. On the other hand, it would be a safe passage to...
Well, it would not be difficult to pretend being captured by the drow.
Is Copper moving around there?
Yes, Copper is stumbling, still blindfolded and gagged, stumbling around in the room and is starting to bump into things.
Sorry, guys. I'm gonna leave him like that. It's okay. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so we now have even more options on what we can do and how we want to progress. Maybe we could enlist our help for them to show us the exit to Skullport, for example, so that we will do something for them and they would show us exactly or escort us there or lead us the way or something.
Well,
I mean, depending on what their conditions are as well, like, if they're recruiting people, I'm not sure they just want to be like our escorts to Skullport.
No, I doubt that. That's why I said we probably would have to make him believe we want to join and then...
Well, we could just ask them to treat us as hired mercs.
I don't think that deceiving them would be like the smartest idea, especially if they have like a war force or a tribe down there. And we're kind of stuck in here.
I have a slightly unrelated question. Did it look like they were friends of the local goblins, or are they like maybe, I don't know, you know when like someone comes and asks for volunteers, sometimes what they mean is like we're forcing you to volunteer right now, you know?
Well, it didn't look like they were like threatening someone. They were just standing there, right, Buffs?
Standing and shouting and demanding an audience with Yek.
Oh, they were demanding an audience with Yek. Okay. Then.
Well,
yeah, we should.
Do not need to make a choice right now. We can still further investigate this.
True.
I think we should ask the local goblins what they think of them.
Yeah. And if we want to investigate more, or we want to barter a deal or something, we would probably have to all go there and talk to him, as he wants to see who he enlists.
Y'all, I have an idea. Uh-oh. What if we enlist Copper?
Oh, actually,
well, that would solve our problems.
That would work, actually.
We can even keep him blindfolded and he wouldn't know a thing.
It would sort of go against my idea of not enslaving him further, but you know.
He'd at least be released, and that's what he wants.
He'll be glad. They can protect him from Helleth, right?
Probably.
Yeah.
Honestly,
like
it may be his best chance at actually surviving, since he doesn't want to go with us.
It's true. Should we ask him? Or should we just do it?
I'm pretty sure he won't be thrilled.
Well, he hasn't been thrilled about anything so far.
You're right.
But you know, in all fairness, leaving him alone is probably the same as killing him. I think it's better if we leave him with them.
Yeah, you're right.
Maybe he can earn his freedom and a means to get out or something.
I guess, I suppose, yeah. Yeah. Well, he did say we should just let him go, so we can just let him go into the arms of this army, you know?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, that'd be quite fitting.
Yeah. Okay, cool. We've decided that, right?
Yes.
It's your slave.
Well, it is right now, but I was kind of hoping y'all would also pitch in, but, you know, just buy him with my own money.
Yeah, you fed him your rations, so he's all yours.
Well,
we're all your slave advisors.
Ha! Indeed. Well, you know, back to the original topic of, you know, what are we gonna do?
I think we should try and discuss it and find out what their terms are before we agree or decide on whether or not to follow them.
Definitely, and yeah. I don't really want to just go to war with the Drow, because I don't know how many of them are down here, and if they would actually...
I think being involved in Warden War with our little friend here that locked us in the dungeon is already more than enough.
Yeah.
I mean,
we don't need more enemies down here, honestly.
But maybe we could pay the bugbears so they take us down there. That would also be a possibility. So they would have something from it, and we would not have to enlist our lives.
Or they could pay us to protect them.
Well, they already
from
came
the
up
drow?
Here, so I think they are
fine. Pretty armed, as far as I...
No.
Yes, they are. It's a war band. Bugbears. Armored and...
Well,
all right.
Let's go out
and grab Copper and give him over to his new life.
All right. Will we manhandle
you
him, or just gonna push him
just
around, or
go over to Copper?
Wanted to ask him and tell him first, or
walk over to Copper and say, "Well, I think we found a solution for you. We found someone who can protect you down here. Would you like that? Is that a yes?"
I think it's a yes.
Please
probably
nod
yes.
If you agree.
He nods like slightly.
Okay, well, perfect. I like rub my hands. Okay, well, Lasha, you should probably go first, I think.
Yes, I will go first. I move out.
And
Alice joins her.
And lead Copper sort of by the chains or whatever.
Yeah, put a rope on his handcuffs so you can just drag him behind you like a dog.
Like a dog leash.
Oh, well, I put my hand on his shoulder and like lead him, you know, before me. There we go. Slightly
life
more human.
Mercenary, mage, slave owner.
Look, I tried my hardest, okay? Sometimes there's no good options.
Okay. While you're approaching the warband, they are having a conversation with Yek. And Yek is speaking common to the bugbear captain. And the bugbear's only option is to reply in very broken common. And you sense that Yek is not very happy about the bugbears just coming in here and asking to recruit forces from him.
All right. Okay, so I like, is it, are they like in the middle of a conversation still, or Did they just have like a little break or something? Because I don't want to just interrupt them.
I wouldn't call this a conversation. Like I said, the bugbear captain really is just speaking a couple of words in common. And Yek is trying his best to look as diplomatic and statesman as he could be. Also failing at that job, obviously. He's somehow not really used to big words and speaking diplomatic. But he tries to explain that he is in a very bad position, being sandwiched between a gang of were-rats and the
all right, were-rats.
Henchmen of Xanatar.
Yeah. All right. So I approach and I talk in common. And Yek, if I may have a word with you.
Visitor, please, you speaking.
All right. You already told us about your problems with the were-rats and Xanathar's henchmen. And
yes.
I think we told you that we are looking for a way to Skullport and safe passage through Goblin or Bugbear territory. So we just came here, first of all, to maybe strike a deal in helping you guys and also helping the Bugbears by enlisting this fellow dwarf that we have gotten from you. So
he looks at Lou for a split second as if he's not understanding what you just said.
Well, I don't even understand what I said myself. So.
Speaking hard.
No, it's okay.
I got your point. Yeah. So you want to trade dwarf?
We want to enlist dwarf in the Bugbear army, and because we want to have, or we want to help the Bugbears, but we also need information or a way to the entrance or exit to Skullport.
Okay. Yek seems to understand you now, smiles at you, stands up and says, "You clever business orc, you really clever business orc. You bought slave from me, now you're reselling slave." And he tips with the finger to his forehead. Very clever, very clever. Then he again speaks to the captain. "You accepting these dwarf to come with you?" And the captain looks at the dwarf. Is also a bit of amused, and then looking at you, Ilasha, asking, "How much do you want for dwarf?
How much should we buy him for?"
$75
I
sort of whisper, "I don't think we should sell him. He's slavery."
Yeah.
I whisper back to Orlin. Yeah, that is definitely your call, and I understand that it was your money.
why don't we barter him?
Or we
for his service.
We.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
So we would borrow him to the just out of character, real quick. So we borrow him to the Bugbears in order to get safe passage or something.
Wink, yeah. Wink.
Yeah, why not? You know. YOLO.
Okay, I tell the Bugbear, so we don't want any money for it, or for him, for his service, not for him.
Oh god.
So we would lend this dwarf to you for your service in exchange for a passage to Skullport, or at least the help to get there from you.
USB has been connected to your PC.
Yeah.
What would you like to do with this drive?
Quick question, Nick. Did the stream hang, stop, or is that just lag?
Did it?
Because I moved you to the actual scene that our viewers can see what is going on.
Oh, yeah.
It just took like 30 seconds. 30 seconds lag, wow.
It shows me that it's fine.
Yeah. Okay, good. Sorry. So,
All good.
Yeah, okay. So you want to trade copper for information or a safe passage down, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's totally not how you treat slaves, right?
That's
how you treat free people.
I am not sure if the Buckbeer captain understands the concept of free people.
Oh, no, I'm not talking about the Buckbeer. I'm talking about our morals here.
We're not asking any money for him. He's free, you know, a free person.
We're just advising him to join the army.
And he accepts. Getting a bit skeptical and is looking at you. What is wrong with Dwarf? Is he cursed?
No, he's not.
He may need some beating into shape, though. I'm just saying.
We actually bought him off a slave auction. And if we just release him in this state, he is sure to die anyway, because he doesn't have any weapons or anything to fend for himself. So we figured that this would be the best course for him to actually survive.
Since when is Orc caring about dwarven fate? Orcs and dwarves have killed each other for hundreds of years.
That is true. But this is very, very far from my actual life. I have never experienced that, so I never grew up with the grudge against dwarves. And we are down here all in the same boat.
You hand over dwarf, we use him as cannon fodder, and we will escort you down to our city.
I look over to Orlin
and pat Copper's shoulder, and I say, I've been cannon fodder before. You'll be fine.
he's a sturdy dwarf. He will manage. Right?
Yeah. Just make sure the studies don't go into you.
Which one's the general bugbear? Is it
one in the front?
All right. Alice goes up towards him and hands over the hand axe she picked up and said, well, at least he can use this in good faith.
You're just trying to put sugar on trade.
I give the bugbear a wink and step back.
He accepts, and Copper is now none of your business anymore.
Yay!
He also says that they will leave tomorrow morning and will stay here on the bazaar for now, restocking on supplies. So if you want to go with them, you need to be there tomorrow at the same time, or you're gonna miss your call. They will definitely not wait for you.
Okay, what time is it?
It is morning.
Okay, so if we would go to bed, like at the normal time in the camp, then we would sure to be...
Yeah, just please make sure to not use Alice's clock, because that is always
I mean, that's a good point. We should probably buy a clock, if they have one. Like, we're underground, we don't technically have an actual way to know what time it is.
You now, for your in-character information, you have no idea if it's day or night outside. You could lost completely your track of time.
Yeah.
You suppose it is morning outside, but you're not really sure.
How do goblins and stuff do this? Like, is there any information to us? Do they have like clocks? Or I think that's very elaborate for them, right? Or too elaborate.
Could be junk for them out of character. I mean, just have it, consider it some partner.
They probably know that clocks exist. The question is, do they have use for that, or do they just follow their instincts and say, okay, yeah, I wake up now, so I'm rested, and I'm tired now, so I go to bed.
True. I see. Okay. All right. Then I tell the Bugbear General that we will be there tomorrow.
Okay.
And
that's a nice clock idea in the Twitch chat.
What did they say?
I didn't have it open. Any magic items that recharge at dawn.
True.
Yeah, I mean, you actually have one of those. So you can just try that item out every hour and see if it's dawn.
How do we know that an hour has passed?
Just your gut feeling.
All right.
Well,
I see.
Well, good. I've been meaning to make I've remembered a purchase I need to make at the market anyway, so I can ask. You can ask for a clock as well while I'm doing that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. In order to seal your trade with the captain, he hands you over a stone, small stone painted with a bloody handprint on it. In case you get lost, here is your entrance to our city. You are now, for now, friends of Azeroth Army.
Thank you very much for this.
What an honor indeed.
Yeah. Just an additional question. If we come to your city, to your village, could you tell us from there how to get to Skullport? You surely know of Skullport, right?
Yes, I know, but we don't go there. More humans, more dwarves, more problems.
But you know how to get there?
Yes.
Okay. Good. Then thank you, and we will join you tomorrow.
He nods, and Yik, on the other hand, is in pure joy right now, because another goblin is approaching the throne and is handing him over a really beautiful, huge cake. And Yek claps in his hands. Yeah! Cake! 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 Kevin, your spider senses tickle a bit.
Oh no. What kind of tickling is it?
Magic tickling.
Oh boy, I can't really cast detect magic, but can I make an arcana check to see if there's any magical symbols or anything like that?
Exploding cake!
on the cake. There's a rune on the cake.
Arcane cake. That should be a spell.
Yes, please.
Arcane cake.
Your knowledge of magic tells you that cake looks way too perfect.
Oh
and
boy.
Also, considering where you are right now, where the hell did they get that cake from?
I step forward and say, excuse me, that looks like a cake. where would we find a bakery here? Where did you find that cake?
Yes, cake. Humans eat cake, right? Cake?
Yes. Well, you know, as a human, I feel like there might be something off with that cake. Would you allow me to detect magic in that cake?
You think it's cursed?
We wouldn't want anything to happen to your great leader, wouldn't we?
My cake? Cursed? Please, check for magic.
Okay, well, I'll be casting a spell, just so you're not surprised. It'll take me about 10 minutes, if that's
please
okay.
Please go forth with your magic.
Okay, I'll go cast Detect Magic as a ritual for 10 minutes. And I'll, okay.
Everybody, the whole hall of goblins is watching you while you do that, and sometimes you hear an ooh. they don't see magic being done in front of their eyes often.
Wave my arms like even harder and sort of make some noises that aren't technically required, but like...
the only performance while you're doing
your oh, okay.
Okay.
Okay. most of the goblins are really impressed by now, and they seem to enjoy the show of your magic going on. Some of them have the glimpse of fear in their eyes since they don't really know what is happening. And Yek is also watching you enjoy and is clapping his hands. Magic! Magic! Magic on my cake! I have magic cake! Magic cake! He seems to have lost it.
Like, when I finish the ritual, I would like to cast a minor illusion to make a few butterflies fly out of my hand. And I smile at Yek.
Okay. That works. So your ritual is done. The butterflies fly out of your hand.
Oh, wait, they can't move actually. They're just static butterflies, you know. Yes. You know, they don't
that
know what butterflies
sad.
Look like, you know. So
yeah,
you know.
I've never seen that. So you have some really fancy graphics effects now added to your detect magic. And detect magic, on the other hand, reveals to you that the cake, unfortunately, is a lie.
No, oh, what Aww. Does that mean? Is it an illusion, or...?
It is an illusion, yes.
Okay, well...
Slow clap. Nice.
Well, I'm so sorry. It appears this cake is an illusion. And a falsehood, in fact. Perhaps, you know, not real.
What do you mean?
It's
not real cake?
I don't
My magic think... cake is not real?
Would you allow me to touch it, perhaps?
Huh. If there's something wrong with that cake, yes, you may.
Well, okay, I very sort of gingerly, like, touch the edge of the cake. In case, like, it actually can be touched, then I would like to not disturb the frosting too much, you know?
the whole appearance of the cake is an illusion. And
okay.
you can stick your finger right through it, and the illusion, as in this moment, breaks and reveals to just be some cooked meat. Nothing really fancy. It actually looks pretty disgusting and is probably overdue.
Oh, I go. Oh,
and
I'm
has the same disappointment now that you ruined the cake for him.
Oh dear. Well, if you'd like me to. Like, make it look like a cake again, I can do that if you want. I'm sorry for destroying the illusion. I know you probably
no.
wanted to have a cake.
No. I wanted to have a cake, yes, but I want to have a real cake, not just some bleh.
Well...
He doesn't really have a word for what he's seeing there. He's very disappointed. I will execute that goblin there.
Wait, what?
No, no.
Wait, please. I just. Let me just ask him something first. And I turn to the goblin and I ask him, where do you get this from, or who gave you that?
He's really hesitant to answer, and but then he chucks for a second and grabs all the courage he has and says, there is magic kitchen to the west.
Ooh,
I got cake from there.
You grabbed it from there, or you made it there?
No, I grabbed it there.
I see.
And I turn back to Yek and I tell him, please spare this goblin, as he did not intentionally wanted to trick you. he was genuinely thinking that it was a real cake and wanted to make you and wanted to bring you a present, make you happy.
Yes. My magic detected very, very powerful magic in that cake. I believe anyone would be fooled by it, except most powerful wizards.
I see. Well, you proved yourself very useful, so I'm not executing goblin. Go, whoosh, whoosh, go. And the goblin runs away.
I throw a look at Elasha and do like a little thumbs up.
I wink at Orlin.
Your detect magic, by the way, also shows you again that the circlet that Yak is wearing is magic.
I'm contemplating where I should bring it up, but I think I won't at this point. But
probably not say that it's magic. But did we ask him last time where he got this from? I think I asked him something about it, right?
Yeah, I think I don't remember what it was, but
I don't think he answered though.
Yeah, right. He just gave a quick answer for us that it's none of our business.
Okay. Well, I guess there might not be a better chance to ask him though now that we like officially have detect magic up. So I'm gonna very cautiously ask Yek. Yek, Master Yek, there's also some magic coming off your circlet. Is it a powerful magic item?
Yes. It is the symbol of my power. I am leader of this goblin tribe. Circlet shows that everybody should bow to me.
I see. Where was this? Who bestowed it upon you?
I found it.
Would you be like willing to tell us where? You see, there is a lot of magic in this dungeon, and we need to investigate it.
More people like you always come and bring more magic into here.
Oh, that's true. I suppose yes. Well, I would just want you to know that, you know, it is our mission to clean up this magic mess a little bit, as best as we
what
can.
What do you mean, cleaning up? This is mine, my magic.
No, not yours.
I can have
yours.
Magic too.
Yes, you are obviously quite worthy of this magic, but, you know Hallister, right? He's messing up things sometimes.
Hello? Who?
Well, he's a very powerful mage that lives in this place.
Ah, the floating eye. Yes. We have seen the floating eye.
Yeah, we have as well. Yeah. He's kind of crazy, isn't he?
It's a floating eye. What do you suspect? That he's tinkering stuff?
Has he never bothered your goblins or anything?
No.
Like maybe closed off.
Only his apprentices.
Oh, okay. What do his apprentices do then?
Weird stuff. Blow things up and trap other things and flying pans and cooking utensils and stuff. You know, magic.
That doesn't sound great. Well, I mean, we're here to deal with them as well, if you want us to take a look at them.
Oh, that would be very good. Yeah, well, would like that.
Great. We will. But yeah.
While you're talking to him, you noticed that he has fallen back into a more basic commoner and is not trying to use big words right now.
Well, I'm hoping that means he trusts me now. Okay, well.
But he is still the beautiful picture of a man. Like really, when you put up a lexicon and look for a beautiful human, that is the picture.
Well, you know, Orlin is attracted to other qualities that he does not possess. So... Very sorry.
Sorry, not sorry.
Well, you know, I nod and step back in case anyone else wants to ask any questions.
No, well, I think that's all I wanted to know.
Yeah, we'll go on our ways then. Have a good day, Jack.
I know Jack. Turn around.
Does an over-exaggerated waving motion with his arm. It probably means that you are dismissed.
Okay, well, let's go. I'd like to go to the market real quick, but or I don't know. Should we reconvene in the room?
The market is still looking at you with their mouths open. They mostly all of them forgot what they were actually doing right now.
Okay. Well, you know, as long as they're like distracted like this, I'd like to like maybe get some discounts there. So yeah, we'll see each other in like 10 minutes or something. Unless you want to come with me.
That goes to you, sure. Group.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sure. I don't know what I would actually do here in 10 minutes.
Yeah, I don't see what I'd do either.
I mean, you could, like, I don't know, discuss what we're going to do, and I'll just off-screen.
She just wants to take care of her laundry in that 10 minutes.
No, I don't. I have another 1 hour and 11 minutes until I have to check on it again.
Ah, okay.
Look, I just want to see if they have some hair dye, you know, for my hair.
And the clock.
Yeah, and the clock. So I'm going to go up to... The adventure.
All in.
Yes.
Hair dye is so last century, and I use disguise self from the hat and change my hair color to pink.
And then
what an amazing use.
I wish I had that, but you know, like, I'd like to have real hair, you know? Like, you can't wear a hat in all situations, if you know what I mean.
But you don't always have to have it visible.
Can you make your hat invisible?
I can make my hat not be there as part of the disguise self.
Well, I mean, but then
I can make it look like a hairpin or something. It's still physically there, it's just like not...
You know, it's just not the same when you're in a disguise. Like, you know? No.
I'm usually with my... I like my hair well enough.
Well... You know, I miss having naturally red hair. It was sort of my brand. Ha, huh, get it? Brand? Yeah? Because red, you know, like flames, yeah? Anyway, I
need to get some a sound dashboard for Kent Lothar or something like that.
Which one would have like hair dye? I guess is there like the one that had spices or?
Yes,
you can rub some cayenne on your hair.
I shouldn't have hair dye, but I'm just gonna ask anyway. I'm gonna go up to the.
You check the different vendors, leaving out the weapons and arms and armors traders because they are very unlikely to have hair dye.
Is Snuggles back?
Oh yeah,
yes, he actually is, and as you approach his stand, he screams in surprise and says, "Ah, please, don't enchant me, please, no magic."
Oh no, I would never do that. My magic is only for helping goblins, you know. And I wink.
What can I do for you, Madam Magister, Madam? Magic person.
Yes, you may call me Madam Magic Person. I think that's a good way to call me. Anyway, do you by any chance have hair dye? I'm not sure you will. I mean, you have hair, right? Goblins have hair. They look like they have hair.
Yes, we have hair, but how? Hair cannot dye.
Oh,
what
no,
do you
no.
Mean, hair
you
dye?
Mean like, you know, like a thing you can put on your hair and then it becomes different color. You know, I like point at my hair and go, look, this is not naturally red hair.
He pulls out a red fedora-like hat.
Okay, I mean, that's a really nice hat. How much do you want for it?
No. 5 silver for you, magic person.
Oh, know, I'll take that. Yeah, I'll take the hat.
Yes, please. No enchanting.
No. Well, Reddit, do you have anything like to keep time with? Like a clock or a watch?
He looks at you and say, we have human devices that tick.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that what you want? Yes?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. He starts to nearly disappear in one of his chests. Like, the chest is probably big enough for him to live in there. And is crawling through things, throwing out all kinds of different stuff. And then finally comes up with a bronze pocket watch. Yes, you mean this? It ticks. Well, it used to tick. Now it's not ticking. He shakes it in front of his ear. Not ticking. I don't know.
Can I inspect it to see if it like is broken or if I just need to wind it up?
Okay, you have a look at it.
Alistair.
What?
You have a look at it, and the it is very used. It has a lot of scratches. But the glass seems to be intact, so it's probably not really broken. I mean, from the outside, it's hard to tell if something in the inside is broken, but it looks more or less intact. Used, but intact.
Okay, well, well, you know, I'd like, well, as it is presently, it's not really useful, but I still like it. It's very pretty. So how much are you asking for it?
It's not ticking anymore.
Yeah, that's the ticking.
Five silver.
Okay, well, I'll take it. I'll hand over 10 silver all in all.
Yeah. It is pretty much junk to him. So he has absolutely no idea what to do with that.
Okay. Cool. Yeah, I'm done then. I'll just at these. I put on my fedora and look proud.
Alice groans and in distaste of Orland's fashion. Just
What are you groaning about, Alice? This is a great hat.
It does not match your physique at all, and
I tip it at Alice.
Why do you strike at my heart?
Well, I think we should go see what Alistair is up to. He's been kind of quiet today. I think he's just meditating, but maybe he can repair this.
Surely.
Yeah, you could. I mean, you can have a try just winding it up.
Yeah. Okay. I'll just try to wind it up.
Poor meditating warlock.
You know.
Yeah, so you start pulling it, and it actually winds up and starts ticking again.
Okay. Well, that's
back to him now.
No, that's useless, though. Well, kind of. We don't know.
You have to.
We don't know what time it is now.
Well, it doesn't matter. We just have to establish something, and then just remember that.
At the very least,
it's the same with calendars, right? It's in this case here, it's before descent.
Well, I'll just can I like change the clock to just be 12 sharp, right?
Yeah, and then sure.
Yeah, we can just okay, we know we started on 12 sharp, so we can at least count how many hours are passing, even if we don't know. Like,
yep.
Yes. Okay, great.
So we just have a glorified stopwatch.
Yes.
Essential.
And a fedora.
And a fedora.
The fedora, yes, very important.
Okay, well, what do we want to do with the rest
of
the day?
I want to check what Snuggle's doing. And if he has new items.
Mm-mm. He is happy to see you. You want to clean more stuff?
Do you have anything new for me?
Not since yesterday, but still a lot of dirty items.
He just wants to
go
leave
over, I feel like I could go over 3 or 4. He seems nice.
Okay. He hands you extremely worthless items, like a large bone that you couldn't really put to some
kind
of creature.
Is it a skull or just a bone?
No, just a bone.
Okay. I'm not interested.
Or,
does
yeah,
he have any
stuff,
wait, does
stuff
he have
that
any
seems valuable to goblins?
Does he have any pot like flower pots?
The what?
I think he's
not understanding the concept
of
flower.
Do you have any containers where I could put dirt on it to make plants grow?
Ah, plants, you want to grow plants? Yes, why didn't you say that? He pulls up a bucket. It's a wooden bucket.
Not quite what I was looking for, but I cleaned the bucket for him.
Maybe something smaller?
I used to grow mushrooms in this one.
What kind of mushrooms?
Shiny
psychedelic.
Ones.
Shiny
the ones,
mushrooms.
The ones that glow in dark.
Do you have any of those?
Not mushrooms, but I still have like earth where mushrooms pop out.
Okay. Would you give me some?
Yes, you nice lady. Why not? Here.
Okay.
He gives you a handful of dirt, basically. With the promise that someday a mushroom will grow out of that dirt.
You know what? I actually might take the bucket too. What do you want for the bucket? Should I clean some more items for you and you give me the bucket with yours?
No more cleaning, no more cleaning. I have to feed family. 5 copper
Fair
for
enough.
Bucket.
I give him 5 copper and I put the earth in the bucket and put the bucket with the earth in the bag of holding.
There's no oxygen in there, it's not gonna...
I can take it out again!
If you remember.
My guess is that on some point there will a micro cosmos develop within that bag of holding all the useless stuff that is in there. Just someday something is gonna bite you when you put your hand into that bag.
I'm not saying that never happened to me. I never put a mimic in my bag of holding. What?
Good. Snuggles is happy.
Okay. I give him 6 copper. He's nice.
Ah, nice lady. Nice lady. Never met elf lady so nice.
And then I join the others.
So how much time do we actually have before we join these bugbears on their journey? Because we still have to take a long rest. How long has it been since our previous one? Like
an hour.
An hour, yeah, right, exactly. So perhaps we could go check out the magic kitchen the goblin was referring to?
Yeah.
Maybe they have some real cake there.
Doubtful.
I doubt it.
But you can always hope. But you can always hope.
Well, for me, I mean, we could get Yak on the good side if we actually manage to find some cake.
So shall we find that goblin and ask him where he found the kitchen?
Well, he said through the west, and there's only so many corridors leading there.
Well, there's all of one, but if the previous floor was any indication...
Well then, where was that goblin? Up north?
He ran away.
Yeah,
he was dismissed by Yek.
Well...
I just want to check real quick what is behind here.
Behind where?
Like...
Ping again?
Yeah.
Ah, there.
I just want to walk there. And...
There is a goblin that is...
there a door?
There is a door and a goblin trying to hide from you.
Hide from me?
Yes, he just got a glimpse look of his face.
Okay. I'll slowly just advance. I only see like
you're slowly cornering a goblin in a corridor. Very interesting. I just want to point that out.
I don't see anything.
Please, don't hurt. Don't hurt. I didn't know cake is a lie. Please don't hurt.
Oh, guys, I have found our goblin.
Oh, okay.
I talk to him in goblin and say, don't worry, I'm not here to hurt you or do anything bad. So please don't feel threatened. Can you show us where this magic kitchen was? We would like to check it out.
You want to go there? Cursed magic kitchen? Get more cursed cake?
That yes, we want to see what is happening there and why there are magic cakes.
You promise you won't hurt me?
I promise. We won't hurt you.
Yap, yap. He agrees and starts running through your legs. Is
ooh, quick one.
Stopping, and looking at you. Come, I show you. Come.
All right, thank you.
Where's my goblin? Is that my goblin? Yes, that is my goblin. So many goblins. Please come. He really is a quick one. And is running.
Oh, yeah, this goblin's fast. Okay. Yeah.
Now it's lagging and rock quite a bit from.
Yeah, it is. A lot of people moving. He is stopping his run, nearly falling over his own feet. So, wait, that's strange. What here? He points at the wall in front of you and says, "No, there was no wall. What happening? Where is wall coming from?"
That's
not a good sign.
Can we push along the wall, see if there's an illusion or something?
Is my detect magic still there?
Yes, it is.
Do I detect anything?
You feel the remains of what kind of magic could that be? Well, yeah, you feel remains of magic, and it is the same as in level one where things started to change.
Yes, this is it. I can sense some magic. It's the same. The same thing I sensed in the first level, where the walls changed. So this is probably the same thing again.
And I turned to the goblin. You're saying that you like here, right here, there was an entrance or a door or something?
We had to come down here at some point. So
yes. What other elf is saying? There was stairway to surface.
Wasn't that one
right
here? No, wait.
Nope.
No.
No, I still see the remains. So yeah.
Oh, that means right, they're locked in level two as well.
Strange, but kitchen is not here. Come, you come.
Oh. Man, he's real quick.
Oh,
wow, what's this?
So, what is this? Yes.
Wait, can you ping me your location for a second? Because here you are. I had a little lag, and then everyone was just gone.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I know that.
In the center of this room is a rusted iron hand pump and a deep stone basin. And next to the stone basin lies a dead goblin.
Oh.
That is Kronk. Kronk used to be my friend. Now Kronk dead.
What happened to Kronk?
I don't know. Kronk dead.
Well,
Kronk wanted
that
to get
sometimes
cake as
happens.
Well.
Kronk wanted to get cake.
Kronk wanted to get cake? And then he didn't come back, or what?
Yes, he said to me he go to kitchen, but never come back. That is Gronk.
Can I investigate what, like, killed Gronk?
Do investigation. Okay, very good. There are no bleeding wounds on him, but his skull seemed to be pressed into the inside by a really big thing, kind of weapon probably. And he is covered over and over with blue marks, blaue Flecke, Hämatome.
Okay. Okay, well, it looks like something...
something beat him blunt. To death.
Something yes. blunt beat him. Is do you know what, like, killed him?
I can only guess. Sometimes pans and other kitchen stuff is flying around in kitchen.
Oh boy.
Most of the time when we're too loud, when we're not sneaky enough, then stuff starts to fly.
Okay, let me just take a quick 10 minutes to recast my my detect magic before we continue, I suppose.
Do you have any other predators or other monsters or something down here? Like bigger lots monsters that could do something?
Lots of people, most bugbears and were-rats. And a draw or poisoned food or falling stones. yes, falling stones, very dangerous falling stones.
Okay, I see. No giants or something, or like cyclopses or whatever.
Giants? You only giant in here.
Okay.
Have we asked your name yet?
No.
What is your name before we, you know, go into battle together?
My name? Why do you want to know my name?
Well, it's customary among, like, surface people that, you know, before you go into battle, you ask each other's name.
Ah, I see. Big people talk. Like Yek always do big people talk.
Yes, indeed.
Ah, my name is Grangak.
Okay, well, I'm Orlin.
Hello, Orlin.
Hello, Grangak.
Hello, Orlin.
Hello, Grangak.
Hello, Orlin.
Hello, Grangak. And I tip my hat again.
When do big people stop with that?
Well, you know, anytime they want, really.
Ah, I see.
Say, do you like Yek?
Yek is good leader, but Yek is cursed. Yek is not like us. Not anymore.
Would you like the curse to be broken?
Yes. Yek is playing like big king, big leader. But he should be one of us.
Would Yek like the curse to be broken?
No. Yek beats everybody that is coming close to him.
I see. Well, let's continue on.
Okay. He rushes to the south. There.
Whoop.
You see that?
No, he's gone.
What? Lighting? Hello, lighting? Thank you.
Yeah, it's a bit lagging. It takes a minute to.
It's weird. I have like 5 foot lighting around. Zoya?
Yeah,
I did that on purpose to so that you just don't lose your own tokens. So I made them to emit like 5 foot light.
Okay,
from there. Okay.
I only have 5 foot light, like as well now. I don't have the 60 like I have. Yeah, I only see 5 feet light.
You have dark vision, right?
Yes.
60 feet, right?
Yes.
I have dark vision too, and I don't.
And my owl has dark vision as well.
Just gave it to the owl.
Alice also has dark vision. 120.
You have a torch. You shut up there.
Okay.
Oh no. Oh.
So Zoya, it is actually that is the thing with the reveal distance on dark vision people and all that stuff. It adds lag.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Okay.
So I'm not sure if we should go on like that or just live with it and have Alice discover everything for you. You know what? That is done. Oh, that is not working out. I'm removing that shit. Wait. That came out of my extended playing time with Roll20, all with myself. Please don't get me wrong.
Oh, no worries.
So that should be better now, right? Yeah. Okay, now he rushes forward a bit. Please, Alice, follow as much as you can. You have the torch.
Let's go, guys.
Oh, stop, up here. Shh, silent. Okay. Silent.
Yes.
Okay.
Kitchen is right in front of you. Be careful. This is kitchen. I can't go further. I don't want to.
I'm gonna walk extra silently.
Extra silently.
I am walking extra silently, in fact.
Yeah.
Upon hearing that we need some stealth here, Alice looks back to the group and nods, and thusly casts Pass Without a Trace. However, Toad already started walking stealthily by this point.
Well, yeah,
it's okay for now. And as you, is that just on 30 feet?
Everybody
each
within
creature. Wow.
Yes. So
the goblin is silently rushing away, out of your trace, and seems to be enjoying himself while not making any sound. You are alone now.
Okay.
Okay, so what you see in this room, a bit to the north, is some kind of an abandoned laboratory, and it's filled with dusty tables and cauldrons. Its stone hearth is cold. Piled atop the tables are alchemical tools and equipment, and all of it is like really old, and probably to the point of being unusable.
And so it's like very dusty, so it doesn't look like it has been used or someone did stuff with it.
Probably not. No, not recently. It's really, really dusty.
Can I look around if I see any sort of maybe traps or hidden doors or indentations or like arrows could be coming flying out?
Or runes.
Where do you want to check?
I'll help you out with that.
I'll just look into this room here. As far as I can see.
I cast Guidance on Orlin.
Okay, so I'm rolling with advantage. and then plus roll.
Do a four.
Yes, 12.
Nice.
With all the help. Well,
you can't see anything else than the obvious.
Okay, well.
It is a laboratory. And it's But as you suggested, the stuff is pretty much unusable. That is very easy to see. So neither the components that are on the tables nor the instruments and stuff are of any use to you.
Well, it doesn't seem anything that's much of interest in there.
Okay, then, as your light shines to the west, you see what appears like to be a kitchen. And from what you can see, it has a washing basin, a hearth bearing a covered cook pot, and some shelves, as well as pans and other cooking tools.
Also, still have Detect Magic since I recast it. in the room before, right? Mm-hmm. Did I sense anything?
What is the range of that? 30 feet, right?
Yes.
Yeah, no, not so far, unfortunately.
I mean, I can put up an aura if you want, but that might lag everything.
No, no, it's okay. I can. Yeah, I'm not sure. Just it looks okay. Yeah, yeah. That is okay. Actually, that is pretty helpful.
Should I leave it on or?
Yeah, I'll leave
nobody
it on.
Nobody else
now.
Sees it. It's yeah, just nobody you else. Yeah.
Oh, okay, nice. Well, let's continue on then.
Okay, now you sense something. Some of the frying pans and other cooking utensils seem to be magical.
Okay, wait, everyone, wait. There, I think the cooking utensils are magical. Do I sense what type of magic it is?
Conjuration.
Well, okay. Well, okay, we should proceed with real caution. They, you know what the Gargugulguk said? they attack people. So, I don't know if we should go in there right now without preparation. Oh, goodbye.
Bye.
Oh.
There he goes.
Blop, blop.
Blip,
welcome
blop.
Back.
Blip, blip, blop.
Ah, there you are. Okay.
That's the downside of using it on your phone, huh?
Yeah, it is. I don't know why it does that, but it sometimes just loses connection and then is not
yeah,
really telling
been,
me about it.
I've been having that problem too, on my phone specifically.
But it's just more or less every 1.5 hours or something like that, so it's actually okay for most of the time, but anyway.
All right.
Good. What was your plan? I didn't get that.
I don't know, I just said we shouldn't go in there without a plan, and then you dropped out.
Yeah, our plan was find the plan.
Yes.
and be very, very silently...
Very planning.
Yes.
Okay, silently planning. Before you come up with a plan, it is 4 o'clock. Do you want to have a 10 minutes break, since we already had a 5 minutes break?
I mean, if there is a potential of a fight, I think it might be smart to take a break now, yeah.
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 Okay.
I'll have to get my laundry in 40 minutes, so that's not really, you know, feasible.
Yeah, okay, so we have shorter breaks then, but from time to time, it's not big of an issue. So let's do, let's do until 4:15. I give you the other 3 minutes as well.
sneak up my own because I rolled I rolled a 29 on stealth and I have a plus 10 because of Nick's thing. So with the 39 on stealth, I should be able to look around the corner, right?
Yeah,
but you're
yeah.
not invisible.
No, but he said that they were like activating on sound, not.
Did he?
On...
Okay. Yeah.
Or did I miss something? Because he was able to get the cake. And the cake must have been somewhere here.
True.
In the thingy.
I mean, I can just try and sneak up. Worst case, I can turn invisible.
Okay, well.
I'm not gonna turn invisible for nothing. Can I just reach up here and like have a look around the corner?
Yeah, sure. That's pretty much the kitchen, what you see there.
Okay.
And on the other side of the kitchen, there is a closed door.
So no visible enemies.
There are no visible enemies. We're still very sneaky. So, that's what you see. It's a kitchen with
come back here,
utensils.
And that's what I tell you guys.
Okay, well, how much space is in there? About?
It is 20 foot by... I think 30? 25?
And did you see... How many cooking utensils did you see in there?
How sharp were the knives?
Did they have a meat cleaver?
Use the Rockwell scale.
All kind of cooking utensils. Some pans, some cooking pots, also some noodle holes. It's a noodle holes. Any idea what a noodle holes could be? Yeah, that.
I'm still not very afraid of pans and pots, so.
Well, clearly you've never run into
called.
An angry cook.
It is called a rolling pin.
A rolling pin, okay.
Yes, rolling pin. It has a pin and you can roll it.
Oh, okay. Well, I can put in a fog cloud and we can like grab them as they come out, maybe, if we make noise here.
If, but shouldn't we investigate further?
I mean, we're all sneaking except for Yagu, I think.
I am also, but
or
a
like
little
Lennar,
bit
Yagu.
Not as well. Just not as well.
Sneaking, some of you are better than others.
Exactly, some are better than others. Okay, the shell makes it hard.
But still, I mean, it's a 15.
It's a 15 with
so
pass without trace.
True. So I would say not. Go and overcomplicate things and just get in, look at stuff, and if we don't find anything, we just.
Okay, but ready your weapons. We don't want to be surprised when they attack us, you know?
I will definitely be surprised when Pants start attacking me, but.
Well, the goblin literally said that's what happens in there.
Alright, I'll ready my sword in case the illusionary cake. Jumps and tries to
don't make fun of me for listening to what the goblin told us. Like,
I just don't believe it. I'm sorry.
Oh my god.
Oh wow. Well, let's go then.
Okay.
I can't really ready my. I mean, am I allowed to ready a fire bolt, sort of in my hands and then shoot it if something happens? It's not technically allowed. But
yeah, it's a cantrip. Do you really need to ready that? I mean, it's basically a snip of your finger.
Well, it still can't cast it when, like... It's role-playing,
yeah, I mean,
okay? Jesus.
Okay, you'll be ready to cast a firebolt.
Okay.
We will protect you. We won't let any pans hurt you.
Yes, don't worry. They might clank
clearly.
And clank, but
okay.
They won't hurt you.
Clearly,
while
none
you
of
march.
You have ever met an angry cook. Otherwise, you'd be as afraid as I am.
Ein Mops kam in die Küche und stahl dem Koch ein Ei.
Well, I would be more scared of the cook than of his pan.
Okay, while marching forward a bit, you start to smell some kind of a stew in one of the cooking pots, and it's really smelling well. It's nearly irresistible to ignore that smell of slow and long cooked meat, together with fine spices and herbs.
Like one of those on here, or
yeah, one of those on there, yeah.
Do you detect like a magic coming from that pot specifically?
Yes.
Wait.
Yes.
That pot's magic.
Oh, what should we do with it?
Well, don't get closer.
Intimidate the pot. No, sorry. does it have a lid on it? Or
yes,
is it?
It does. Yes, it does. And some steam is coming out of it.
Okay, so we just let's try to focus and stay in reality and not get carried away by some illusion. We know that this is not real. There's no one in here cooking. So we just ignore it, or
still, everybody do me a will saving throw.
Wisdom, okay.
Wisdom?
Wisdom? Yeah.
Yes, wisdom, excuse me.
Hey.
Windows.
Okay, everybody is everybody except Zoya is able to resist that smell. And Zoya is thinking, man, I didn't have a proper meal in days since we're trapped down here, and is slowly approaching the pot with the irresistible stew in it.
I notice this and try to hold her or grapple her so she doesn't reach the pot.
Okay. That kind of works, Zoya.
I mean, if the thing that's attracting me, the stew that's attracting me, is not stronger than whatever I think I'm, do I kind of snap out of it, or or do I fight against it? Like, do I want to try that stew so badly, or
you really want to try that stew? It's really, it's smelling so good, so good.
Oh, so... Tony, like, I really need to try that stew. Like, I need to try and taste out the recipe. It smells delicious. The children at the orphanage would love it. Like, I need to try it.
Snap out of it. It's not real. You have seen the cake that Jack got.
Or it's real.
But this one
it's not real.
Much better. Like, the cake didn't really smell like anything, but this one just smells so delicious. I need to try it. I need the recipe.
Okay, Alasha, what do you want to do? Want to hold her? Do you want to really hold her back, or do you want to persuade her?
Alice would like to persuade Zoya and give her a slight bitch slap of reality.
Bitch slap.
Shake her out of it. Zoya,
okay,
look.
Do me a persuasion while you talk.
Bitch slap of persuasion.
Zoya, look.
Jesus.
Look. That cake was made from grotesque rotting meat. Do you expect this pot to be any different?
I don't know, but it doesn't smell like grotesque meat.
Okay, then give me another wisdom saving throw then, Zoya.
Yeah. Amazing.
Okay, let me quickly calculate. Yeah, it's kind of working what Alice just did to you. That slap made you come back to your senses, and
okay.
you can resist it right now.
Okay. Maybe you're right, but it does smell delicious. Like, I give like a longing look to pot, but I don't try to
get it. To have better stew when we all get an actual campfire started and we can make one ourselves. Even Alistair has spices, huh? That'd be nice.
Do you remember
I mean,
that part we found? I almost
I mean
died.
I can change the the taste of my food as well. I can make it taste more delicious.
Nice. There you go.
Okay, so
I guess
I am approaching the pot, and I'll just take out my weapon, and I'm just trying to like poke it, if I can move it, like to see if the pot is real.
The pot is very real.
The pot is real,
the
okay.
Pot is very real, and as you poke it, the lid just flies off.
Uh-oh.
And the next thing you see is that the steam from the pot is turning into a specter, while four different cooking devices start to float.
Sorry, guys.
Around you.
I told you so!
Oh, wow. Floating knives. We had these at home, too.
Please, there's no appropriate token for that. Please consider that to be kitchen devices.
Okay.
It's all right.
The pocket, and pocket then sword. In this case, please, people, roll for
you
initiative.
Know what it is.
And just click on your token first.
Oh, right.
Yes.
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 Okay, wait, I'm going to just move my owl for a second so I can...
Hey, buddy!
Hello.
What's happening?
Amazing.
Okay.
I might be able to be at the top of the initiative. Barely. Near the top, at least.
Oops. Why is that not properly cleansed?
You need descending, not ascending.
Yeah, but it still has
Okay, I guess that works. Like, my owl has 21.
It's something.
Oh well.
At least one of us is fast.
It's anything. The old turn order from the last fight in there, and that is, I don't know why that happens. So I need to double check it again. That is Orlin, you're double. You have a 7. You have a 6. That is.
I mean, on our end, it's showing up correctly.
Yeah, it has like both entries. It has the one from the previous fights, yeah. and wait a second. So that is you, Alice. You have a 6, or the 17 is right. Alistair is not present. Christy has a 21. That's the owl, right?
That's the owl. Yeah, I have a 12.
You have a 12, so that one is incorrect.
Still the fastest of us.
Where's Yagu?
Here.
Yeah.
11?
Ah, there,
right,
11.
Right,
yeah. Just was confused with the names. Then this 4 is incorrect, and now let's sort it again. Descending. There you go. Owl goes first.
The owl will hold action and stay there and help when someone attacks the spectre thing.
Okay. Then it's your turn.
Well, I'm gonna attack
it. What kind of initiative role is that? All of you below 15.
I don't know, but I'm gonna move over there and have the owl distracted, and I will attack it with Booming Blade and Vicious Rapier. So, did it roll twice?
Yes,
it did roll twice.
Booming Blade. Okay. So it's 25 to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
So it's 9 plus 3 is 12, plus 7, 19. 19 piercing, plus 6, 6 thunder. And I will move back here.
Yeah, apparently the thunder doesn't seem to do much on the spectrum.
Okay.
And then it is Spectre turn. Okay. Is that ranged? No, it's melee. So it moves. Can you remove the aura? I have a bit of a difficulty seeing your tokens.
Yes. Give me a second. There you go.
All right. Thank you. It moves into the line of Alice and is using its life drain ability on you. And is hitting you, so please do me a constitution saving throw.
Of course, constitution.
All right, okay. So in this case, you're just getting 9 damage.
All right.
And it's Yaku's turn.
Okay.
So if the thunder doesn't do anything, the 11th thunder from moving probably won't do anything either.
Sorry, question first. What is the initiative of the kitchen utensils?
Oh boy. The same. Yeah, I forgot. But wait a second. I need to put some initiative in there.
Can you beat
We should have just not said anything. Then we wouldn't have had to fight them.
Can you?
it is. It is a very low initiative.
Can you?
So that is then after. Yeah. There you go. Okay.
Can you beat a kitchen utensil to death? I am curious. Okay, so what's more productive? Can I actually maneuver? Yeah?
Yes, you've been muted for a while now.
You are I've been talking to myself. Great. Okay.
You just probably missed like a half an hour ramble of turtle talk.
Yeah, okay. Am I able to beat a kitchen utensil to death? I'm not entirely convinced. So is there, can I maneuver over here? I'll provoke an opportunity though.
You are in melee range with 3 enemies at the end of the day.
3 enemies?
Yes.
Huh?
Just have a look around here. You have a kitchen utensil to the north. They don't need to be straight in front of you.
Oh, I'm still in range of all these. Okay, great.
Yeah, you are in range of all of these.
Okay, so then I just attack this one.
I know, you're down there.
Yeah.
You see, I forgot that I mistook your token. No, in this case, you just have that kitchen utensil.
Oh, okay then.
I just was looking at the wrong token. Needs to move my map marker there. Just go on.
Okay, then I think I'll provoke the opportunity and move over. What the heck just happened?
Okay.
Alistair said it again.
You just needed to move my map maker.
Okay, so
see your tokens.
I'll take the opportunity and move over here.
Okay, you'll get an opportunity attack by a flying
spoon
animated pan. Aww. Where is my pan? Why did their pans disappear? There it is. Stop that. The longsword. No, pan. And it misses you.
Great. Then I start punching this guy.
Yes.
Where is my rule?
Punching.
Commitance punching. That, and then
that hits, and
2 of these.
That is enough. Stop it. It's okay.
What? Okay.
Let the specter die in peace. Don't piss your
pants. The specter disappears into thin air, and at the same time, all the cooking utensils clash down to the floor.
Oh, okay.
Oh, the fight is over.
Well, that was easy.
Yeah.
You were right, Elasha.
Can I cleanse that here somehow?
I was expecting that a goblin would probably have a little bit more problems fighting these things, but I figured that we should be capable.
It's one singular goblin going in there and then probably having problems.
Getting smashed.
Proportionally, a goblin is gonna have the same amount of trouble with like a weak enemy as it's gonna have with like a dragon. So it doesn't really say anything. Like if a goblin.
Yeah.
Goblins usually have a risk to die in the morning when they get out of their beds, right? Okay, you successfully calmed down that kitchen. The smell disappeared. The pot is empty. There was no stew in that. Sorry.
Do I sense any more magic?
No, the magic has died.
Okay, there's no more magic in here, so I guess it should be safe.
Does that go through walls?
Wait, let me just read up on it.
I think not, right?
Usually says something. The spell can penetrate most barriers, but is blocked by 1 foot of stone, 1 inch of common metal, a thin sheet of lead, or 3 feet of wood or dirt.
Okay, 1 foot of stone. In this case, no, you don't sense anything, right?
Okay.
Yeah. But I just asked myself the question, what, like, did the specter just cause everything, or where do these things come from?
What school of magic did I detect from the pot? Again, it was conjuration, right?
They are animated objects.
Yeah, so I don't...
flying swords, but in this case, pots and pans.
The school of magic that I detected seems to indicate that they were sort of animated, or conjured, maybe. So I believe there's probably someone making these pots that isn't the specter itself, I would say.
The pots are still there, by the way. The pots and pans and all the cooking utensils did not disappear, they fall to the ground.
But something
they're
has
still there.
To
but the magic
like create cakes and stuff like that.
Can I examine them to see if there's any like magical symbols on them or anything?
No. Absolutely. I mean, yes, you can, but no, there's nothing.
Okay.
Sorry. They're really common cooking utensils.
This is a door, right?
This is a door.
So, I still think that something is causing this, which could be the Mad Mage himself or something, but... Maybe you want to check out if there is something behind the door that is causing all this?
Yeah, but out of character, I need to go check on my laundry now, so if we could take a 5-minute break. Sorry.
No worries.
Let's do it another 5-minute break. No, it's all right.
Be right back.
Days usually stress me out as well.
Oh yeah. Always the beeping of the machine.
Oh, everything is taking so long on that. That is just to wash, then another 2 hours to tumble, and then another hour to put everything away. And
yeah.
That's why I just don't do it.
I just
buy new clothes every time.
Okay. Yeah. Very good.
I don't tumble my clothes now. It's warm enough outside that they dry faster if you put them outside than if you throw them in the
tumbler. I just like the feeling of tumbled.
Mm. I only tumble like underwear and bath towels and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, towels. Towels are really great tumbled. Getting so soft, smooth.
Mm.
Oh yeah.
And if you just hang them, they get very stiff and rigid.
But apparently they take up more water if you just hang them and let them dry naturally.
Yeah.
Tumbling is actually not very good for towels. But
yeah.
I still like it, so I don't care.
I can live with that.
Thank you. Okay, we now have Orlin with the fedora.
Yes, truly beautiful.
Probably gonna need some Christie rework.
If she wants to have one with fedora, we can do that.
Nick, are we supposed to understand what you wrote in the chat? Is that Greek?
Me?
Yeah, you.
Twitch chat.
Twitch chat, did I write anything?
Mad Match chat.
Did I write anything?
Yes, you did. Your own nickname.
What the fuck? How did that...
Some Yidznil.
I have no idea.
Did you just type in some passwords or something?
I think I was typing somewhere else, and then that went in. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. So Toad needs to listen in while we will continue for now. So
all right.
Have fun hanging your laundry, Toad. Really sorry for
dirty
you.
Dirty laundry.
No, it's not dirty anymore. It's washed, but it's wet.
You don't know. You haven't seen
it. Well, I suppose when it's coming out of the washing machine, it's not dirty anymore. Okay, so...
Well, maybe the washing machine is broken, too. So.
You stand in front of a closed door.
All right.
I will try to open it with Mage Hand.
Okay, it opens.
I mean, if I see it from here, like, I don't know, I don't see anything, like, everything is black up here.
Yeah, because the door is closed, you need to move past the door. It is open now.
Yeah, but I don't see, like, no, I used to see a bit more, I don't even see where the door is.
Huh.
I only have the 5 feet thing again.
Yeah, because you moved out of the light cone of Alice.
Yeah.
Wait a second, we just move Alice here, and then you see a bit more.
Okay.
Should I look away?
I hope I don't have to roll. I hope I don't have to roll a save to not lie on the bed, because like I would just straight up go and lie on the bed.
I follow Zoya and I move in as well.
Oh, wait a second! I forgot a thing. The door actually has a sign written on it in common, and it reads, "Calabar's room. Do not enter unless your name is Hallister."
Oops.
Too late.
Okay. You see a lot of furnishings. A dusty bed and stands with a headboard against the north wall. At the foot of the bed rests... Yes?
As I enter, I announce, my name is Hallister now, if it allows me to enter this room freely.
Yeah, you read too much Harry Potter.
Hey! It works in Call of Cthulhu. It actually saved my life. Like... Okay.
Okay, at the foot of the bed rests a locked wooden chest. It has a lock visibly hanging on it.
Wait, where are you guys? Are you in here? Cause,
mm-hmm. Yes, yeah, yes, okay. Yes.
Because I just don't want to reveal accidentally anything.
No, go on. And where was I? And a desk in the southeast corner has stacks of musty old tomes atop it. And on the floor is an old rug. Woven with arcane symbols. I just moved Orlin here as well. So,
yeah, Orlin probably wants to check the tomes if there's something that she can use.
Yeah, Orlin's detect magic is still up. And the rug radiates an aura of abjuration magic.
Abjuration is...
Alice check the rug with an arcana check to see if she recognizes symbols.
Abjuration is protection spell. Like barriers and stuff. Okay.
Yeah, for example. then...
And that comes from the rock.
Yeah, kind of. The rock seems to cover something. Do me that investigation check that you wanted to do, or Arcana, whatever that was. Nick.
Oh.
Oh wow, very good.
Very
good. Okay, you see that under the rock are some kind of arcane symbols on the floor, painted on that. And do you want to remove the rock?
No, just to lift up to check those runes, not completely remove it.
Okay. Yeah, you checked under it, and it seems like a few runes are missing. But having a closer look there, you would actually, yeah, you would be okay to reconstruct that, to add the missing runes.
Orlin, what do you say about all these runes? Should we go about reconstructing the magic circle here, or whatever it may be?
I don't know if Toad is actually...
actually available. Oh, no, she's typing. She's typing.
Ah, she's typing. Where is she typing? Ah, in
the man-made.
Oh, yeah.
Channel. 5 seconds, okay. One.
Two.
Three. Four. Five. Oh.
Probably once she heard tomes, she just...
she just dashes to the mic.
Superior fireballs.
Fireball plus.
God, I'm back. Okay.
Welcome back.
Don't worry.
Okay, wait, hold on. I need to like.
The superior fireball was a lie as well.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It was like the cake.
I can't the fireball.
And the delicious stew.
Yeah.
Wait, okay, so I'm examining the dusty tome or something, aren't I?
No, the runes on the floor.
Okay.
The runes on the floor. Yes. And while you do that, you also notice that the lock on the chest seems to be magical as well.
Okay, what kind of magic?
Runes on the floor for abjuration.
Exactly, runes on the floor abjuration, and the other one, why don't you never say that?
Should be abjuration too for protection. I mean,
yeah,
it's a lock.
Yeah, it's
makes sense.
Yeah, both.
Well, those seem to be sort of locked, I guess. Can I make an arcana check to know what the rune is? I guess. Oh.
It's like you were asleep during that class.
There's magic on the lock of the chest, and there is magic below you, right where you're standing right now on the rock. And there are some hidden symbols there that Alice revealed. And Alice is probably able to explain you a bit more about it and give you a little lesson.
Orlin remembered sleeping during that class and says, Yeah, they're probably like a magical rune. Yes.
Yeah. Well, my sister told me about these, but I don't know whether it'd be wise to complete the circle or whether we should erase more runes. But I mean, it shouldn't harm us to try something, certainly.
Well, if a spell goes off, I can counterspell it.
True. I mean,
if anyone has. Well, I probably should have picked up that spell that lets me dissipate magic.
Alice, yeah. While you're thinking about it, it seems to be when you put that picture in your head of the circle with all the complete runes, it's probably a summoning circle.
Well, it probably summons something.
Yeah, my sister told me about these things before. I think this is why I... know so much. Would we want to consider summoning whatever this would summon, or shall we just leave it be? They could be hostile, they could be friendly, they could be neutral, you don't know.
Well, I mean, considering this is a bedroom...
And the specter in front of us Could have been a safeguard.
Huh.
What say the rest of the party?
Yeah, considering it's a bedroom, just like summon the succubi, right?
Ooh,
who cares?
How scandalous.
Unless they're dead. What was over there on this little this old boop 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 there desk? Yes, thank you.
The desk has 20-ish old books on it.
Can I examine the books to see if there are any magic?
They're not magic.
Okay, what they're about?
Apparently all of them are empty, blank pages.
Hmm.
So nothing. They are thick and well made, so you can probably sell them for a reasonable amount. But they're blank.
I'd like to take all of them. But
I all 20 books.
Yes.
I hold my bag of holding towards Orlin.
How many gold worth of transcribing materials would those books be?
Each book would shave off 10 gold of your transcribing costs.
We'll take all of them. Is there any ink flying around? Can we also take ink?
There's also some ink, yes. That is included in those 10 gold.
Okay, well, we're then sort of gleefully hands over all these books to...
How many tomes?
20. To Zoya. Is there anything else on the desk?
No, that's it.
Okay, well, it was already worth it for just for that to come in here. Well... Well, what about the lock? Ken, is there any way we could maybe... It's magical, I can tell you that.
That makes it a bit more difficult for me to open it then.
Yeah.
I could dispel magic.
That would be great, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Cool. You do dispel magic on the lock, right?
The lock is where the magic is coming from, or right?
Let's rephrase that again. There is a chest with a magical lock, and there is a summoning circle hidden under a rock. That is that red thing that you're standing on.
Okay.
Or not standing on right now, but in the middle of the room, that red rock, that has a magic summoning circle below it. So there is magic from the lock and from the floor.
Yeah. So we know that the circle isn't complete, right? There's
something
missing.
A few runes missing.
Okay, so then I would dispel magic on the lock.
Okay. Seems to work.
Great.
But I'm assuming it's still locked.
Well, you didn't hear any clicking sounds.
Rogue, might you want
to... Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's why I'm asking. Like, am I assuming it's still locked? That's what I'm going to try to do. That was the plan. But before I touch stuff, I wanted to make... Come on!
You are breaking your thief tools.
No. Can I try again? From a different angle?
We could just shoot the lock open.
Oh, fudge. Alistair is not with us. But I don't have just like one thing to try and lock.
Yeah,
I usually have a set of tools.
Yes, go on. You can try again.
Can I help? Can I like help Zoya somehow?
Yeah, wait. I call guidance.
I'll pat Soyos back there.
Hey!
After the initial failure, Zoya pats on her hat with her flat hand and concentrates and focuses and actually manages to open that.
That's
47.
That wasn't
and
a flag.
He manages to open the lock. A clicking
That's my
sound
favorite
appears,
eye.
And in a very tense second, no trap goes off. Everything seems to be all right.
Okay, I take a step back, and I use Mage Hand to open the it.
Okay, the chest opens. You want to look inside?
Yes.
Okay, in the chest is one singular note, piece of paper.
I pick it up with Mage Hand.
Okay, that piece of paper reads, Retirement Fund. Don't spend this on ale, Calabash.
Calabash.
Otherwise, the chest is empty.
Well, guess someone did spend it on ale.
Well, you know, that's not a bad way to spend your retirement money.
Never said it was.
Well, I don't detect any magic anymore, right?
The magic under your feet?
Yeah. But not from the chest.
No, not from the chest.
So, can I try to use my mage hand to sort of investigate it for like a false bottom or something like that? Oh, 40 year old, sorry.
Sorry, there is no false bottom. That chest is empty.
Okay, well, that seems to be it. Have we heard the name Calabash before?
Group?
I asked the group, yeah.
I don't remember name.
Wait, let me check.
Neither does Alice remember a name
I need
Calabash.
I need to, like, pick colors to at least see which names we already heard. But I don't... Wait, there was a room with the three statues that had new names. No.
Give me a history check.
I don't remember anything about those. It's not noted in my notes.
It's not in my notes either, but...
Zoya, you
remember...
Yeah.
Calabash, right?
You exactly, Calabash. You remember that that was the name written on the door.
I just wanted to ask, but I was like, no one else thought about it, and I was like, no, I must be mistaken something.
No, it's more like, did we hear it somewhere, like I was
earlier
thinking
on.
About, like, earlier
no.
on, not like
yeah.
on the door.
No. Otherwise, that, I don't know how common that name is, to be honest with you, but otherwise you didn't hear that name.
Also, those are the names on those statues that we found.
Yeah.
I wrote them down. That's the only thing I wrote down. I was like, oh,
okay.
My time
okay.
is gone.
I have those three too.
Oh god. Okay,
Does the bed and stuff, does it look like it's been used recently, or...?
No.
And you're...
So it looks a little bit abandoned.
It looks abandoned and dusty.
Okay.
Could you repeat the content of the note, please?
The note says, Retirement Fund. Don't spend that on ale, Calabash.
Okay, thanks.
Alright.
Okay, well... should we maybe destroy the summoning circle?
It is already destroyed. I mean, it just needs two rooms. Someone would have to inscribe them.
Yeah, but like, what if they're like really close to completing it? And if we destroy it, they'll have to redo everything.
I suppose. I mean, do you want to strike out the runes, Orlin, or
if, according to your previous check, you actually find it pretty easy to reconstruct the runes, so someone with a bit more attention in magic school would definitely be able to reconstruct the whole circle.
Well,
so if it's easy for you to reconstruct that, it is probably easy for everybody else as well, with like just some arcane knowledge.
Well, I mean, we've already raided the chest. It's not like they'll be like alarmed that we were here if we like make us a mild inconvenience.
Well,
but I detect active magic from them, so they're not just, you know.
Well, then what say you to crossing them out with our weapons, or is there some other process to this?
Did I actually detect magic when they were covered?
Yes.
Okay.
It's just a rock covering it, so yeah.
Yeah, why don't we like try to sort of scratch them out? Like, how are they written? Are they like scratched into the stone or?
Chalk.
Chalk. Okay. Well, I go over and use my foot to like scratch out.
And you could use the rock.
With every rune that you wipe away, the magic starts to faint a little bit more.
Okay.
Alright, that seems to be working.
Yeah,
you want to eliminate the complete circle? You want to remove all of the runes?
Yes. Okay.
Then that was successful. There is no more magic to be detected there, other than just the faint remains of it.
Hmm. You suppose that was magic chalk or just regular chalk?
I'll make a note of the runes in my. Well, can I get one of the books, please? So
I give you one of the books. And the ink.
Yes. Okay. I make a note of the what the circle looked like in my book.
Alice holds a finger to her head, and then hands out a semi-solid thread. Orlin to help her transcribe.
Oh, thank you. What's that? What are you?
What?
Well,
oh,
what?
This. Oh, it's just some nifty trick I picked up, my tutoring from my sister.
I
quite,
see.
Quite useful for taking notes.
I see. Thank you.
Your sister seems like an interesting person.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, she's great. She was the form of the family. A lot smarter than I was. That indeed. Much more studious.
Okay, that worked. Nice little trick.
Okay.
I want to check the mattress if there is like, I can feel that there is something in it or something. Like maybe the money is being hidden in the mansion.
Money! We're doing a heist here, it's not...
or something else.
Raid the kitchen! Raid the kitchen's funds.
Okay, investigate the bed.
I don't have the advantage, so yeah.
Very dusty and, very basic.
Well, looks like just some basic old bed thingy, so
we can at least take the mattress.
It's not fitting.
Oh.
What do you want to do with that?
Carry it on my back so it's better than my cot. No, don't worry.
I mean, you have a non-magical bedroom right now here, so for future reference.
Yeah.
With That's one good. Bed.
We can all fit in there if we try.
You can take turns or like really cuddle.
We can just lay like this, then we can put three people on it.
I don't think we're at that stage of our relationship yet, y'all. Like, we've been through a lot with each other, but I don't think, you know, I mean...
Crap, how bad did I write that? Okay, that looks awful.
That looks like dead.
I'm writing with my right hand, which is not the hand I write with, and plus a mouse.
Are you a lefty?
Yes, I'm a lefty.
Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't notice. Okay. Then. What's next?
I take out my wristwatch, pocket watch, sorry, and look at how much time has passed.
About another hour.
Okay.
Including the fighting and investigating and doing checks on runes.
Well, okay, we've taken about an hour. It's not too bad. Let's continue. Is this kitchen, like, functional? Could we cook in it?
Yes.
Okay, well, cool.
You have to do excessive cleaning, but yes, it is functional.
Well, if we find any flour, eggs, milk, and sugar, we could make a cake here.
For Yek.
Yeah, then we can impress him.
Yeah!
Oh, wait, but this place looks awfully dusty. And Alice takes out her cleansing throne and just slams it on everything. That looks like it could use some cleaning. Just up, 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 up.
Oh, that's a cool stone you got there.
Well, it's not without its uses.
Well, let's see what else is in the other room with the broken equipment. Before we go in there, I'd like to sort of take 10 minutes and recast my detect magic.
Okay. Okay, okay, okay.
Should I put up the aura again? Or?
That smells good.
Oh, no, it's alright. Oh, yeah, I mean, you can put it up. It was not impacting performance for me. It was okay.
Just
that specific situation where I had problems seeing the sepia-colored tokens in the sepia-colored aura.
Oh, boy.
While doing your detect magic this time, you don't feel that stinging behind your forehead anymore. And it actually feels better than ever before.
Oh, strange. I haven't felt that thing anymore now. It feels really good to cast magic.
You didn't mention you wanted to cast magic as often as possible earlier, but...
Yeah.
I'm glad that sting is gone.
Yeah. Well, maybe that was just sort of an adjustment to maybe a... higher power level that I have now.
Maybe.
I feel more powerful in some ways, maybe.
Well, that's great. It's always good to feel empowered.
Zoya, do you remember? I remember you also having. Did you say that to us actually?
Yeah, I did. I did.
Okay.
Yeah. And for Zoya, it is stinging with every mage hand and every
and
other.
And every booming blade. I'm sorry, Buffs feels really sorry about me hurting every time I cast Booming Blade.
It's just, you know, crying inside every time.
A lot.
I'm sure he made up this entire
drowning,
mechanic.
Drowning my sadness in alcohol.
Yes.
Okay, so...
So it is beer that
before.
You open.
No, it is water. It is canned water.
You know what
yellow
vodka means
water,
in
but it is
like,
water.
Translated, right? You know?
Yeah, it is water.
Yeah, vodka. Anyway, yeah.
The room is the same as before. Still no magic.
Did we like go up into the corners here, or did we not see that yet?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
Still no magic. Alice, please, okay. Please follow the group. You are the light bearer.
Please.
Whoop-de-whoop.
Oh, thank God. Okay.
And thus there was light. It's Alice.
Is there anything we can see that maybe is interesting? Any sort of tools?
Or of value?
Yes.
No, nothing of value, really. The ingredients that once were there are rotten. The equipment is also pretty much useless, and it looks like it hasn't been used for years. And the goblins didn't seem to have any use for that stuff, so they left it there.
Could I investigate for like a hidden room or something, hidden door?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you investigate really closely. And you have the feeling that you haven't left out anything. But still, the room is a room.
Okay, well, I don't think there's anything here, so...
Are there any recipes in the book? In the room?
No.
Too bad.
Well, let's continue on somewhere else, maybe.
Maybe the door is no longer blocked now. It's possible.
You mean the staircase up to first level?
Yes. Ah. Sorry.
Oh. There is a door on the other end, though.
Yes, that is true.
Are we curious enough to go poke our nose there?
Yeah, why not? It's still early days.
True, we do have a whole day to go until we leave.
Just in general, like, do we want to use that day that we have left and try to solve the X magic problems, or do we just want to
yeah, you're right.
Explore a little bit and then follow the bugbears down.
I think the X magical problem is something more long term, because
okay.
But yeah. I mean, we don't know if we can come back. Like, if we follow the bugbears, we might just be like locked in with them.
Well,
the bugbear said that it was like a 4-day travel down there.
Yeah, but I mean,
so it's not like we can just go up and down as we leave.
Yeah, exactly.
We can't always do everything.
Yeah, I mean, Yek seems happy. The goblins
are not happy with it.
It
seems we have an amiable relationship with him. So.
Yeah, I mean, he's not harming them in any way. He's just kind of weird, you know? Which is allowed. You're allowed to be weird.
Yeah, he seems rather childishly weird, but...
Alright.
Fair enough. So you want to check out the door?
Yeah.
Alright. Yeah, sorry, buffs,
As you approach the door, you see that it's actually not closed. It's just hanging in its angles and has marks of blunt weapons being smashed against it.
Looks like there was a forced entry.
You can freely move through it if you want to.
Law enforcement, maybe? Well, going in.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll follow.
Behind that door is a well-maintained workroom.
Ooh.
With reeks of rotting flesh and ozone. I don't know if you have a laser printer. If you have ever been in the room with a laser printer, that is what it smells like.
Oh boy. Do I detect any magic?
No, not for now. And,
okay, well.
Can you move me? Where did why is it lagging for me? It's kind of lagging for me, and I keep losing you. Yeah, yeah. I didn't move anywhere that I haven't gone before, just so I don't. Okay.
Wandering around.
Yeah, it lags and doesn't update it. I don't know why. Then everyone just disappears.
Oh no.
They are odd metal instruments designed for measuring stuff, topped tables. Along with several loose scraps of parchment with notes.
Can I look at the notes?
Yes, you can.
Only with my eyes, not my hands.
Yeah, most of them are just lying around freely. Some of them are turned downwards, but most of them are readable. And there are terms on it like rate of decay and accumulation of charge without any context. They just lose notes laying around everywhere.
Okay. It seems like someone was doing some science in here.
Oh no, not science. That's heresy. Oh no.
You see, out of your peripheral vision, you see what could be resembled to be a bigger note with stronger and more valuable paper.
Let's go look at that note. Where is it?
On one of the tables.
Okay. Yeah, I look at the notes, and since I don't detect magic, I'll pick it up and look at it.
Okay. It seems to be a log entry, and it says, day one, Halastar has granted me this abandoned copper mine in the Arcane Chambers. Finally, I have access to the components needed for my experiments.
Can you put me the text in chat, please?
Yeah, sure. There you go.
Thank you.
The room has an exit to the east, northeast.
Do we hear something? Or like
you have a pretty high passive perception. No. No, you actually can't hear a thing. It is dead quiet.
Well, Alice would like to walk up to this table and see what she finds. That be investigation or perception?
Investigation.
Boop.
If you really want to actively look for something.
Yes.
Okay, a lot of different notes. And do me. Wait a second.
Yes.
What kind of check could we do there?
Science?
An insight. Do me an insight. Yeah, science. Do we have science? No, we don't have science.
No, you can make it one.
Yeah, no, do me an insight.
Yes. There's your insight.
Oh, okay. The notes are all kind of related to electricity.
Oh, I did. Oh my. Electricity or something.
Do we know what the electricity is?
Well, Alice.
Yeah, when
does.
Thunder strikes you, you feel electrified. not thunder, lightning. You actually know what electricity is because you can do lightning bolts and it makes fizz. And
but we don't know, like, electricity as in, like, electric lights.
No,
not in the sense that we know.
Yeah, not as a tool as we use it, but you know that it exists and that you can do magic with it.
Okay.
Well, this, what do we make of this? Because could this man be trying to bring some power into the dungeon, or could it be trying to charge something?
He's putting up a production line and will some kind of four-wheeled chariot.
His notes are talking about experiments. Maybe
he's gonna name it. He's gonna name it Model T. And black.
Well, I thought more about
the
Cybertruck
or nothing.
Maybe he developed a hairdryer for all the goblins down here.
Oh yeah, they definitely need some. Well,
alright.
Guess we'll hang on to this information for later if we come across somebody who looks like they're experimenting with thunder magic, lightning magic, and all that.
Well, that's unfortunate. Well. If you have a metal armor, be wary, I guess.
Yes, yes, I know. Keep my distance.
Thunderstorms and lightning, very, very frightening.
Yeah.
Should we advance?
Do you advance, exactly, thank you.
I would like to send my owl, or... Elasha.
Send Elasha.
Send your Elasha, yeah.
My Elasha.
Yeah, I'm quite confident that there's
nothing in here. Okay, the hallway continues south and then to the east, and you have a glimpse view into another room where you see a lot of barrels, probably like a dozen.
This seems to be like a storage room of sorts.
I want to inspect the barrels right in front of me. See what if there's something in it and what is in it. And...
What's on that hammock there? Sorry for the taxes.
Okay, you inspect the barrel. Hey, congratulations, you smacked the jackpot. As you inspect the barrel, you hear a rumble out of the barrel, and the lid starts to open up. There is a ghoul that unfolds. Where are you? There are you there. Wait a second, I need to reveal that token for you. Token layer, there you go. There is a ghoul cramped in that barrel, trying to come out and hit you.
And some sort. So. Alice, do we have time to react at all, or it's spot, like super quick?
It is initiative time.
Okay.
Go, Owl. Wait, now. Whoops.
Where's my token? Here she is.
Jeez, these initiative rolls.
Oh, come on.
Oh, sorry.
Wow, getting double numbers.
Just don't use fireball, because we don't know if there's any gunpowder or something in it.
Alice is full of gunpowder.
Okay, then...
Oh boy.
What is that, 18? That is all, right?
Yes, for...
Also, I'm
hey.
For some reason I didn't change my HP after we did the long rest.
Ah, don't worry, you didn't take any damage.
And
okay,
also,
so all in oversees all the stuff that is happening from the back and is able to react first.
Well, seeing as there's some barrels with unknown contents here, I will pull
fireball.
Out my crossbow.
Blast the fucking hell out of the room!
Bullets going fucking high!
I pull out my crossbow and sort of give it a little tap, because this is the first time I'm using it, so I'll go
tap,
attack.
Tap.
20 to hit.
Yay, nice. You hit! With 6 piercing, that works.
I sort of, I'm glad that I still have, you know, my martial prowess for so long as a wizard.
Okay, you want to do anything else?
I don't, yeah, no.
No. Okay, woohoo time.
Yeah, it will hold action until next one attacks the thing.
Mm-hmm. Then it's your turn already.
Can I climb on this barrel?
You need
or
first
wait, like, would it like
yeah,
how much
yeah,
movement?
That would take that would be one
would it...
opportunity attack. No, it wouldn't be if you move clever. Then you can climb on the barrel. Yes.
Would it take for the movement, or would it take from the action?
Take from the movement.
Okay, I don't care about that one. I have 40 movement. Okay, then I'm going to attack it, and the owl will support it. Attack it with Booming Blade and the Vicious Rapier.
Go, go, go.
23 to hit.
Yep. That is, yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
So it's
that is enough. You kill that poor little ghoul, and its flesh falls back down into the barrel.
Oh no, poor thing.
Whee!
I was just scared. Oh.
Yeah, exactly. You just woke him up and then murdered that undead. Okay, so that was a scare. You want to investigate more barrels?
I got down from the barrels before they start opening them up again, and I use prestidigitation to clean my blade.
Okay.
It's important to have a clean blade.
Well, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
If you have blood on it.
Very important. Yes.
Well,
so
do we want to...
Still, 11, about 11 barrels left.
Well, Alice will investigate the one over here.
And having seen that there was a ghoul coming out, I prepare and as an action, I raise my warhammer.
It's whack-a-mole time.
Yes.
Whack-a-ghoul. Whack-a-ghoul.
Point. Point.
Whack-a-ghoul.
Okay, this one does not seem to have a ghoul in it.
What is
and it is empty.
Oh.
Hmm. Need to quickly take a note. We had this one and we had this one. Okay. So
do we want to continue opening barrels? Or is this enough to pique our curiosity? Okay. I'll open this one.
I mean, do I detect anything? Any magical barrels?
Do the same again.
Wait. No, you don't detect magical barriers. I had to. Okay, this one is empty as well.
Yeah. Why would you have barrels with nothing in them?
Yeah. To put something in there. Like, for example, ghouls.
That's so unclassy. Well, what would you find over there, Alasha?
Oh, I'm going to open up this one.
Okay, this one seems to be filled with fist-sized chunks of copper ore.
Oh.
Nice.
Oh, we can make some tools out of that.
Is there like any way that we as our characters can like learn smithing or something like that?
Yeah.
Once we're on the surface.
You can, I mean, if you really want to take the time, I mean, smithing, not even learning smithing, but smithing itself takes quite some time.
Okay.
The question is there, where and how would you like to do that? I mean, learning smithing is a year's task, so multiple years, and then smithing items is a matter of weeks in order to actually get a usable, like, let's say a sword, for example. That takes a week already. That is an off time activity that you usually do between adventures. Like, let's say, for example, you have different quests and you say, okay, we stay in Waterdeep right now and then go on with our quest for a couple of weeks. Then you can do some kind of off time activities. But right now it's bulky to do that.
Yeah.
Okay, while the rest of the people are investigating stuff.
How much copper ore is in there?
It is,
or is it just
total,
like a barrel?
It is the complete barrel. The barrel is full of copper ore.
Okay.
Zoya.
Yeah, that was my.
While Zoya is starting to pack ore into the bag of holding.
Oh no, I just hold the bag of holding and they can take the barrel and start pouring it in.
Excuse me, yes, elves. Yes, they don't get their hands dirty. Yes, I see.
All right, Alasha, let's pick this up. Okay.
Okay. Well, all of you start to ore. Orin notices a hammock behind her that is laden with blankets and hangs from anchors in the north wall.
I very cautiously pick up the blankets one by one.
Mm-hmm. Tucked into the folds of the hammocks, moldy blankets, is another page of that log. The only legible text reads, Day 365. I no longer trust the other apprentices. What they see as mysticism, I know to be science. I can't stand their incarnations and their mutterings any longer. If any of them try to intrude on my laboratory again, they're in for a truly shocking surprise.
Can you copy-paste that too, please?
Well, it seems like there was some sort of conflict between the apprentices. Also, it mentions a shocking surprise.
In with the electricity theme.
Yeah, we might want to be cautious then. So that we're not surprised by the shocking surprise.
Who could we... Alice, you do that again since you started to discover all that stuff. Do me an insight again.
Where is it? Here it is.
Yeah. Okay. Close enough. As you pack the ore together with Alasha into the bag of holding, You start to listen to what Orlin just read to you guys, and you're kind of questioning what you're doing there right now, since you know that copper plus electricity is no good.
But it's in the bag of holding.
And I relay this information to the party.
So...
Yeah, but like, I mean...
full of copper ore and hints into electricity really make you kind of uncomfortable.
Well...
But if we get rid of the copper, I mean, by packing it and then eventually exchanging it...
Oh yeah.
You know, we get rid of it right here.
There's
so we don't have to worry about it.
In Poland, getting rid of copper of other people.
I do hope we don't find this particular acolyte in any hostile situation, because they could do some very nasty things with all this copper, especially if they were already putting them good to quote-unquote good use.
I mean, if we take it, they can't take it to use again, right?
Well, it could be that this is the reserve.
Well, at least they don't have the reserve.
True.
Okay. All right, guys. Then you want to investigate more barrels or anything else?
I think we've dilly-dallied enough.
How many are left to investigate?
You got 1, 2, 3. There are 9 left.
Oof. I mean, we got like 4.
Oh, 4. Excuse me. Yeah. Then there are 8 left.
Okay, wait, let's...
I mean, it's not like I want to spend like an hour opening
so we have
a barrel. But I also don't want to miss anything.
I think you guys are standing on the fort towards this one, right?
Yes.
It is those 4 here, down here.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, we could just open all of them at once.
Yeah, the ghouls. Like, if there are more ghouls in there, then we will kill them pretty fast. Anyway.
I mean, there could be dragon in there, maybe.
Baby dragon.
I want to tame a baby dragon one day.
So you run around with a bag of holding that is packing everything, but you assume that the barrel only holds what the outside dimension of the barrel suggests?
Yes. You have a problem with that, Bavs?
Well, you know, if we die opening some barrels, that's kind of like funny.
I mean, it's one hell of a way to go.
Yeah.
I think I can hear Buffs clicking through the menus looking for dragon tokens right now.
Okay, Elasha, you noticed that the door to your southeast is actually plated in copper. While you're discussing to open barrels or not.
Plated in copper.
Yes.
Does that tell me anything difficult?
No, it's just a copper plated door.
Okay, all right. So we're gonna open all the thingies?
The barrels? I
at
mean,
once?
Might as well.
Yeah. Let's find out.
Oh, 9 rolls of.
Wait a second, this needs to be that. And then, okay, you open all the barrels, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them contain more ghouls.
Yay!
Oh.
Yay! Cool!
So, in this case, then, wait a second, let me prepare.
Amazing.
Yeah, you are ahead of your things.
You're truly the pinnacle of genius.
Yeah, and now you can roll for initiative, please.
Man, I'm getting run-of-the-mill.
No, but are you guys seeing this?
Because yeah, your owl is quicker than you.
Your owl is just... Yeah, give me, please, another one, Christy, just that I can have you in the...
she rolled a 4 at first.
Yeah, I know that she rolled a 4, but I need her token.
Oh, God.
True.
in the turn order.
Two ones in this initiative.
Okay, that is a and then we do that.
Descending.
Hello.
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 We are all very sorry to inform you that Alistair died.
What?
There was a fire in the... No.
We just stabbed him. We were just like, let's stab Alistair. Why not? You know?
Okay.
Yeah, Copper is our new friend.
Where are my goals? Definitely didn't sound. You are standing on my goals. Move away there. Duh.
Okay.
We were here first. Tell the goals to leave.
Yeah, no, you're standing on my goals. Wait. Okay. Flappy Bird is first.
Flappy Bird will hold action until I attack a ghoul, then support me.
Okay. Then the ghouls are approaching. That is how ghouls sound. I'm a professional voice actor. Yes, please.
It's no glitch in here.
And the ghouls attack. Three of them surround Zoya and start attacking with their claws.
Yeah.
Slash, swoosh.
Let's see what that is owl again. Can I quickly? Thank you. Okay, then we have two hits.
Okay,
I'm
gonna use my reaction to uncanny dodge.
Okay.
So then the first one is half.
Yeah, then it is still 18 damage.
That hurts.
1-8.
Ouch.
Wasn't expecting that from some Pope Legal.
I mean, it's three of them attacking.
Yeah, exactly. It's a lot of attacks. So. It's not like they're really clever. They just go for the first thing that they see. And then with that, they are pretty dumb. It is Elasha's turn.
All right.
Smash him to bits.
Seeing that Zoya is surrounded by three of those fuckers, I use...
Let's see what happens.
I use Healing Word on Zoya for 5 HPs.
Thanks.
And then I am just attacking the ghoul in front of me with my Warhammer.
Yes, you hit.
Alright, and I use I do 17 points extra damage with Touch of Death. It's 17 points of necrotic damage.
Yeah, okay. I was just checking how exactly that works. Yeah, okay. That is that poor ghoul is falling into pieces.
Nice.
It is dead.
And then I move forward a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Alice and Orlin, both of you.
The same time?
Well...
Yeah, who has the higher...
I have plus 3 dex.
Constitution.
Yeah, plus 2. So you go first.
Okay,
yeah,
Alice.
Then it's Alice.
Alice shall use a few attacks from her sword at the ghoul directly in front of her, and 1-2, slashy, that'd be 5 plus 8 and then 6, oh wait, no, sorry, that'd be 5 plus 4 and 6 plus 4, either hit.
Wait a second. Doesn't matter.
No problem.
What did you save? How many?
What's the save? It's 13.
No, the damage, first of all.
Oh, for the 21, it's the, it's 9, and then second is 10.
What? Total damage, how much damage did you do without saving throws to having an account?
17.
17. Okay, thank you. That is not enough, so I need to do a saving throw. That is, yes, what my question.
Sorry.
And then the saving throw was 14, right?
It says 15. 15 con. 15.
Okay, and then it takes the other damage as well, right?
Yes.
Now it's dead.
Okay, cool.
So many numbers. Rambling numbers.
And Alice will then move up, up here.
I'm going to start playing D&D for the roleplay, but it's actually just math.
Yeah. And thusly, she shall end her turn.
Okay, then Orlin, your turn.
Well, no worries, it's very simple. I cast Firebolt at the one in front of me. Oh, man.
Oh, you miss.
Oh, the Firebolt flies up into the floor.
You're probably more used to handle a crossbow instead of hands. So no other actions, no bonus, no nothing.
I don't really have anything.
No happy ending.
That's the wizard life.
No.
Then Zoya's turn, please.
I will attack this one with my owl supporting it and with vicious rapier and bonus and booming blade.
Go, go, go.
18 to hit.
Ooh.
Yep, that hits.
Okay. So it's 12 plus 9, 21 piercing and 4 thunder.
Yeah, it's a lot. Okay. Another ghoul blisters in thunder and is taken apart by the sound waves of your booming blade.
All right, I will use my bonus action to disengage and move here.
Out of the
into the wall.
No, okay. I mean, here is still like in the room for me.
Yeah, well, one second, Yangwu. I was assuming that Zoya has higher.
I mean, it doesn't matter. It's the same thing. We both have the same on our initiative, anyways. So.
Ah, okay. Well, then it's your turn.
Yeah. So I'll just move up to the golden.
Mhm.
And commence punching. If it ain't broken.
Commence punching. Punching engaged. No. Yes. Yes.
And it takes, 14 damage.
Okay. It takes a lot of damage. And some limbs are looking like they're falling off.
Nice.
Very soon. The next attack of that specific ghoul would probably not be a melee attack, it will be a ranged attack. Just by swinging its arm, it will disengage from the launch.
Nice. Then he is unarmed.
Yes, partially.
But it can use its arm as an improvised weapon, so...
It is the turn of the owl.
Peck? Sorry?
Peck?
Owl? It's gonna hold action and support the next one that attacks this one.
Okay. Then it is time of our poor little ghoul. Both of them. And since he cannot really follow its initial target, he tries to hit Yagwu, the poor turtle, with his claw.
Yeah, it's the first time anyone ever hits the turtle.
Yeah, but it's not working. It's not following the command of that poor little ghoul anymore. And the other one is trying his luck on Orlin.
Mm-hmm.
And is also not hitting.
Oh, ha! This time I dodge it very gracefully, you know.
Okay, then Elasha, your turn.
I cast all the dead. Are they hurt? The other two?
One of
them. This one's hurt.
Yes.
Okay, then I'll just do it. I'll just, because I have 2d12 if they are hurt and 2d8 if they are not. And because of class passive, my Toll the Dead hits two targets. So
just one of them needs to be hurt in order to pull it off. Or
no, it's just it the difference rolls, like both have DC 13, but mm-hmm. if they are hurt they take 2d12, and if they are not they take 2d8. That's just the difference.
Oh, okay. 2d8 and you rolled,
that is 2d12. Yeah,
because you are above fifth level already, right?
Yeah.
Isn't it increasing with fifth level something?
Yeah, on fifth level it is 2D. On first it is 1D.
Anyhow, this one there is dead.
Good. And the other one would take like the same damage unless it does the wisdom save.
Yes, it did.
Okay. All right. And that's it for me.
Okay. Alice.
Alice will do the same using
Schmite.
Yes.
Do the Schmite.
Schmite.
Holy
Schmite.
Okay. She will. If any of her attacks hit, she shall smite. Boop, bop. And where's the all powerful smite? It's all the way down here. Boop. Oh, excuse me. Oh wow.
So that's 20 if I see that correctly, right?
6 plus 13 plus 6.
That's 13? You're holding that two handed?
No, second attack.
Ah.
You have 4 plus 2 and then 10 plus 3. I'm holding it one handed. I have a shield in the other hand.
Yeah, okay.
Shield.
So in this case, then it is enough to
yes,
smite
obliterate
that ghoul. Smite that ghoul where it came from.
Yeah.
To Ghoulistan.
Perfect.
Okay, fight is over. No more ghouls.
Did we find something valuable in the other?
Yes, two other barrels also are filled with copper ore.
Okay, so we have
Zoya.
Did we find any more notes or something? Okay. Then we have 3 barrels of copper ore.
Yeah, you basically have 3 barrels of copper ore in loose ore because you did not pack the barrel, you have the ore. That would be fun taking it out.
No, I mean, I can just, like, empty the bag of holding and just go for the copper ore.
Okay, the two chunky girls, Alice and Elasha, help you put...
the funny thing is, Alice is petite in physique, but she has so much strength.
Yeah, and all that armor is definitely not adding to her chunky
girl. Oh, right? Nope. No, totally.
Not at all. Okay. That was the fight. The other barrels are empty. No more notes. You stand in front of a copper-plated door. And we are very close to being 6 o'clock. So I personally would say end it here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Except you guys have... just don't
I'd,
want to
I'd like
end
to
it
try something.
You want to try?
That's fine.
Oh,
no.
I'll take like 4 steps back.
Hold that thought until next week.
Ooh, I'll forget it by then, but okay.
Then
write it down.
We invented those devices that leave markings on paper.
Oh man, you can write things down.
I had like a list of things I was gonna do in this session. Like I had to write it down on the bus one day. Because I forgot so much.
Okay, I wrote it down along with my other notes.
What are those like other notes? Don't eat the smelly chicken and
don't eat plates.
Don't eat plates. Don't.
That is definitely not a note that exists here in that.
give Alistair my gun so she can use can use the pepper.
Don't eat magical stew.
I don't need your gun. I basically just have I just have 1 pound of dust of choking and sneezing now.
Oh, that would be yeah. That was very useful. That
I should definitely get more of that.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, we're still like intruding.
Yeah.
The thing. Maybe we should message Alistair and have him join.
Yes. Before we go update on everything.
Yes, please
one
update Alistair.
Yeah. I'm gonna send you a message.
Tell me what happened.
We sold the dwarf to a bunch of.
Officially close the session now, or do you want to?
Yes.
Thank you guys for playing. It was a lot of fun today with you guys, as always. And see you again next week. Also, thank you for watching on Twitch.